everyone, and welcome to the Procrastinators Podcast with me, your host. Well, the best guy ever is away on a tiny island off the coast of Hawaii having a hand-to-hand battle with a bread garlic house, just like the end of Metal Gear Solid 5. Who
else? He's more like he's having a hand-to-hand hand job, if you ask me.
Yeah.
In a handshake. They're shaking each other's hands with their penises instead of their hands.
Okay, but let's talk about that. Like, whose grip do you think is gonna come out on top in that,
Hey, everybody! Reporting in from the island of Jamaica, originally from.
Wow.
It's me.
I fucked this up.
I'm Bread.
Is this the African Undertaler? Has he returned?
Bread, have you joined the podcast at last? Bread, have I? No. Did our plan to depose Nate and put you at the top of the poll? No.
Oh. The plan was a failure. I'm Nate. I consumed Brad.
I'm twice
as strong as I've ever been.
I planned for this contingency as well. It's fine. Let's just continue.
More than anything, I've absorbed his incredible professionalism, as you can see, to still be here despite being on vacation while so many of our number are just unbelievably lazy embarrassments of human beings.
Total ghosts. Just no sense of common decency or decorum, I would say.
They've gone ghost, and they're not coming back, and that's just how I like it.
Yeah, it's sad.
Forgive the echo, forgive the lower mic quality. I'm using a lowly Moids Blue Yeti round-ass microphone. Instead of my pristine recording environment.
You mean a blue snowball it is what it is. If it's round?
It's probably.
I got my snowball ice, which I think is just a snowball but white. So pretty good. Yeah.
I don't know. Blue cool. microphones. It's wait, snowball ice. Oh, it is a snowball ice.
You got a snowball ice too, my dude?
That's what it says on it. Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah. This is Michelle's. Jeez. This is Michelle's.
Dude,
that she bought
so interesting.
When she asked to use my microphone
We're like
years ago.
On a
and I just beat
wavelength.
The shit out of her for daring to, you know, want to use my property.
I beat the shit out of Econ and stole this one from him. So, like, birds of a feather.
I know he's not using it to make any videos anything.
We each had to kick an Asian's ass to get our snowball birds of a feather.
And it feels good.
So how's you guys been, huh? How you feeling? How's it going for you?
Well, I, like Gib, am now an islander permanently. Wow. And it feels good.
Wow.
Gib, do you identify with being an islander like Sora from Kingdom Hearts? Because you live on a big island? Or is it too big?
I can't believe they took Sora, a native islander, a member of the native islander population, and whitewashed him when they cast Haley Joel Osment in Kingdom Hearts.
I mean, if I traveled more around Britland, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
I usually just go from here to London and then to other cities, depending on if I need to be there. But usually I don't go to the seaside. Mm-hmm. Like the old days when mother and father, they get us all in the car and drive down to the beach. And there it would be the beach. And then we'd look at it and it's okay. But
You know, I wonder, this island is obviously, I mean, I'm on Oahu. That's like the main populated island in the Hawaiian Islands where Honolulu is and stuff. And they talk about how people can get, like, a little stir-crazy after a while living here. And, like, it is pretty small. Like, you can easily drive around the whole thing in a couple hours. But if I were to think, I'm kind of inserting my normal day-to-day life in Cincinnati on top, like, of this place. I, like, travel maybe, like, 2 miles, maybe three, like, in a day. I think it'd probably not make much difference in terms of my daily, like, living on, like, a little island versus anywhere else. Just because, I don't know, like, everything I do is on a computer. The most thing I do driving is, like, to take Michelle to work and, I don't know, go to the store, which is across state lines, I guess. Although, I guess that across, like, because I live in the Ohio River and stuff.
You cross
and
state lines to take Michelle to work? Do you just happen to live really close to the border?
Cincinnati is right on the Kentucky border. It's, like, the Ohio River is right there, and across that is Kentucky. So I go do my shopping at, like, the nice store in Kentucky. In, like, Newport, Kentucky or something.
Didn't know that. Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
Southwest Ohio.
Is there a situation where like, okay, all the fucking sovereign stater anarcho-capitalist libertarians live in New Hampshire yeah. because they have like low taxes and like people here cross the border to New mm-hmm. Hampshire to buy like cigarettes and booze and stuff because it's
to buy their beautiful flavored vapes, man. It's a yeah, paradise yeah, over it's, there. It, yeah.
True.
Hey, did you get your flavored vapes yet?
I did. They just arrived like 2 days ago.
Thank God.
Thank you. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But anyway, I was wondering if there's like a similar situation with like Cincinnati, Kentucky. Like, we better cross the border to get like, I don't know, illegal fireworks or whatever because they're legal over there but not over here.
Ohio is like very, I guess the word is liberal. Like there are very open laws and like gun open carry stuff is all good to go in Ohio. Although, I don't know, me and Michelle were like going to do some gun shooting just for fun the other day. So we went to a gun store. This is a couple months ago, I guess. But like we didn't follow up. We're going to do it one of these days. But like they said, they actually are like getting a little restrictive. So like I did, based on what like the guy selling stuff was saying there, it like does seem like things are a little bit more constrictive. So like absolutely, people like in Cincinnati, it's like you know a 10-minute drive and you're in a different state. And I'm just judging based on stereotypes and nothing else. I assume Kentucky is like more liberal than other states because Ohio's like it's weird. Ohio is technically in the Eastern Standard Time block. It's like the most western state that's still Eastern Standard Time. So when I moved like what felt like across into fucking eternity from my parents, like in Massachusetts and stuff, I'm still in the same time zone. But the whole culture is like pervaded with like southern influence and stuff. So Kentucky and all that shit.
Is it a culture shock just like from like a short drive across the border? Like suddenly you're hearing a lot more accents?
You know, you hear a lot of accents in Ohio already. But of course, it's the reality that I live on the internet and rarely interact with other human beings in real life.
That's the way to do it.
So, you know, Michelle probably sees way more than that doing working on the real world.
Gotcha.
And I was going to say that like, the thing about here, like, so Michelle's dad was in the military, so he has all these awesome military benefits, and like the place we live now like used to be a military compound, whatever, it's public now, but like the point is that like we live like right across from the ocean, and like Diamond Head is this giant mountain that's the edge of a crater, that's like a famous Hawaiian landmark on Oahu. You can see that from I'm gonna stand up and pull the curtain, and I can see Diamond Head out the window. Pay no attention to these.
Could you go mine those fucking things?
Yeah. It's right there, and like the beach is there, and like this morning,
good old
for
Diamond
Helmet
Mountain.
And, like, I tweeted about it. I called it Diamond Back, like an idiot, and looked like a fucking fool to everyone.
That is pretty rough.
No, that's incorrect. It's Diamond Head. I went down to the beach this morning, as I've done many times, as the sun was rising from like 6 to 7, and I just did yoga on the beach for a while, and it was, still going on, and it was a great time.
That's so nice for you.
It was really nice for me to do
that. That's so fantastic.
So cool. So, I'm listening.
I know I said this before, but like I tried men's yoga. It's too hard. It's too shitty.
You gotta
I hate
do the girl
men's
version?
Yoga. It's literally makes me want to kill
do the
myself.
Girl version
yes,
it's
girl
easier?
Yoga
That's
is a
funny.
Thousand times
That's
better.
Funny.
Don't follow these fucking red pill men's God. Rights activists, MGTOW
that,
motherfucker
the,
yoga
That's the
idiots
one thing
on
that I really think we should adhere very closely to gender stereotypes on, and I don't really support what you're doing.
Which brand of yoga you ascribe to? No. You want the gay namaste?
I don't think
stuff.
That. Frankly, Nate, I don't think that decision is valid of you.
That's fair. Let's see. Well,
okay.
Try
again.
It's been a great time.
Yeah.
I will, Ben. It's too. I go to the gym and I lift weights there, and I come home and I do my pussy yoga shit because I'm there for flexibility, right? I'm there for getting the knots out. So that's what I'm doing. Highly recommend.
I go to the gym. I lift weights. I go home. I put them down. I stole them.
Yeah, I carry them home. It's a cyclical operation. I don't know. Just the general beach activities and stuff. Haven't been working. Been a little concerned about these. I've been sending emails once in a while about all the channels
being stolen. I have given up
hope.
We're doomed.
Staying up to date on that.
I'm convinced we're fucked. Yes.
Really? after 16 or 17 days now.
There was another guy. I mean, another Mars Reviews who also had his channel taken, and they just fucking deleted his whole channel. I'm convinced that that's going to happen to us.
Okay, that could happen. But even if it gets deleted, it can come back. YouTube has the authority to restore all deleted videos, and even, I think, like, set back the clock if they get fucked with to some previous state. So I've got some hope. And, you know, there's people out there who have Pandapopolin, I think that's him, has like, downloaded, like, every video on every channel. Which is probably, I mean, I don't have every Canton video. Digi edits all those. I don't have every PCP
video.
And
it's a nice thing, a gesture.
Yeah. I did, and then TFAP told me he also did have every TBAP video download. I probably have, there's probably a couple like hidden ones that I got that he probably wasn't able to, but like those, the TBAP channel is backed. I mean, I really don't want to have to make a new channel and lose all the comments and lose all the views and lose all that history. But I mean, yes, we can re-upload those and probably others. So
Nice. You know, you could go to the videos as they appear still and like copy paste the comments into a document just so that you have
them. Yeah, but nobody would see that.
No, but it, you know, like if there's a, like a comment from like I don't know 2014 me, then it's like, oh, that's what I said back then. That's how I talked. Like, you know, that would be a sort of thing you just want to be able to read it again.
That's like so fucking hard.
You could then, it's a lot of work. I mean, if you really care about keeping the history, that's one of the ways to do it.
Yeah. I suppose that's true. You know, once it was slightly unrelated, but like one of the things that's been happening on Bestie Boy is that like for whatever reason, the hackers have just decided maybe just like to get more views, to get more ad revenue on the channel or whatever. I don't know, whatever it is. They've been publishing my unlisted BGE monthly cast on enough, I guess, just like get as many views as possible. Love that.
The worst thing about that is people thinking that you have it back and they don't get it.
Oh yeah, that is.
They just sort of like, it's all fine now. No, it's not fine.
A little bit of comfort in that my. I've got another ominous thing to say on that front, but it's I don't know exactly which channel these are. Okay, well, I was gonna say that the newest BG monthly cast is on like just like a, one of the other little like zero sub channels I had just for whatever test upload purposes or whatever. So that exists on there. If you're a patron or whatever, you can find through the Patreon. But like, I'll say this, you know, I've been working on some projects for 1,000 years. There are videos that are pieces of unfinished projects on all number of channels that I'll just like the real terror for me, the real fear of God is in those unfinished projects getting published and people seeing what I've been up to in the unfinished state.
So like the Ghost in the Shell scene where you are running naked through the streets, like that scene that you already filmed.
Exactly. That I was planning, when I released, I was also planning to kill myself in real life, and that was going to be like a really cool synchronicity thing. But I'll have to do it after it comes, and that'll be a real bummer for me. You know?
That sucks. That's fucked up.
That video where I planned the release, the gender reveal of my son was going to be timed with one of those. I just spoiled it, goddammit. Well... you know, all stuff like that. And like, and the current video I'm editing, you know, that was like, it's like mostly done and I had it like large, I'm pretty sure I put these on other channels, but they might be on there. And oh my God, if they publish those, I will just be devastated. And I just hope that they don't. I don't know. They might. They might. So we'll fucking just delete them, guys. Just delete them, Brad, if you're listening,
please delete those videos.
Please. Just leave them alone.
Brad, listen, you're a reasonable man. We can negotiate this.
The good news is many of those are copyright claimed. Like, a lot of the reason to upload was to test copyright claim stuff. And, like, everything there generally gets claimed. So, hopefully, they'll be like, well, there's nothing to gain here anyway.
I went to the Twitter. Okay. I was on the Procrastinators Twitter, at TP Procrastinators, and I clicked the channel link, and it was like, this channel does not exist. And I was like, oh, my God, it's happening. But, no, it's just because they changed the channel name.
Thanks, guys. Very good. Oh, I have one other. This is a big piece of news, everybody. I'm in a liberal hellscape out here. It's a true nightmare because in this godforsaken state of Hawaii, where you know, up is down and left is right, and gay is straight, etc. It is the rainbow state after all. Like straws are like illegal, or at least like heavily drinking taxed straws or something.
Do you have the paper ones?
They sell the paper ones. Gross. They've got all kinds of stuff.
That's so okay, gross.
But there's one. I mean, this is kind of a silver lining, I suppose. We went this morning and we had French toast and Bloody Marys for breakfast at a local eatery, which was wonderful. But as straws in the Bloody Marys, I'll upload a picture of this. They have a very long cylindrical piece of like rigatoni pasta. Ooh. Or something,
you know,
like that.
You know what?
That
makes
is
sense
the
to
straw.
Me. That makes
that
sense to me. I think that
right?
sounds okay. For a Bloody Mary,
it's not bad.
For a Bloody
it's,
Mary,
it's a little,
like because it's a
starchy
tomato drink, and you're drinking it through a piece of pasta. Yeah, I totally get it.
It's not bad. Here, I just posted in the gross, disgusting audio links. Go look at that. Go look at that. It's a beautiful drink, obviously.
A pizza pasta.
It's a rigatoni.
That looks nice. Is this cucumber or lime or what is that?
These are actually pickles. These are pickles.
Okay. Pickles. Gotcha.
Yep.
Looks pretty good. That looks pretty.
Anyway,
pretty good.
Once you go right, you'll feel all right. End these lefty cucks forever, everybody.
Yeah.
Damn
yeah,
them to hell.
That's a great segue into what I wanted to talk about. But I might go on for a while. I might have to rant
that's
and
fine.
Rave for a while. Speaking of lefty cucks, you guys been following the primaries this week? You guys been following
bit.
The Iowa caucuses? It's pretty good.
I have like
pretty cool
like Twitter level knowledge of that. Mm. Like, what is?
Oh,
please
God.
Explain.
Okay. Let me try and back up and be as succinct as possible in trying to explain what's going on with the United States presidential elections this cycle. Okay. Mm. So, do you guys know what the Iowa caucuses are?
To choose the representative for the party?
But the thing is, it is not a primary vote. It is a caucus. And what that means is people have to gather up in a fucking gyms across the state and literally,
and
like,
lift weights to decide who
whoever lifts the most. No, they have to, like,
hell
move
yeah.
around into groups and, like, gather into crowds to, like, vote for their guy.
Yeah.
Okay, before the primary, before the caucus, there was a...
Wait, vote as in, like, they... cast a vote or people
they
count
basically
the crowds.
Count the crowds, but then if someone is if someone doesn't hit 15% of the crowd, they're deemed unviable and they say, okay, this candidate's out.
Okay,
you guys can realign yourselves if you want to, and those people can like go either way. A lot of people in the Yang crowd were like disappointed that Yang was not
fuck
viable
this.
And they went over to a lot of them went over to Sanders. A lot of Biden crowds were not viable, and those people probably went and shot themselves or whatever. So it's this really okay. That's not even it's really complicated. There's like okay, there's these two alignments. You move around in physical crowds. They count the heads. They total them up. There's like some arcane mathematics to determine something called SDEs, which are like state delegate somethings, and then those state delegates
electors?
Go from each precinct to they each go to like some fucking shadowy like core place, and those SDEs all like convene and cast the vote that's been decided for them, and that determines how many delegates each candidate gets, right? So it's like you think the fucking primary, you think that like the electoral college is fucked up and too complicated. The caucus system is like way worse, right? It's so bizarre.
I'm wondering that if the caucus, how does the app tie in if they're caucusing in person?
The app, okay. So this caucus happens. They record. They do their fucking shit. They record the results.
Mm.
The DNC, the people running it, they're given this app to report the results to the DNC.
Oh, okay.
And the app fails. The app just completely fails. Last time, it took them like 2 hours to have like most of the votes tallied. This time, it took them 3 fucking
days. You know what
would have worked?
An Excel spreadsheet would have done that job.
A fucking pencil could have done it. All right. So there's this huge... Now I'm sitting there. It's caucus night. I'm watching the results roll in. I'm sitting there for hours and hours just waiting for it to roll in. And I see, a couple, if there's like 1% reporting in, and it's like, oh, it looks like Sanders in the lead. Buttigieg second. Wow. Didn't expect Buttigieg to be second. He was kind of trailing. And then Moore comes in. It's like 1.8% results in. And it's like, oh, Buttigieg is in the lead. Like, what? That's kind of weird. But it's like, okay, this is 1%. This is not representative. And then, like, Buttigieg comes out ahead, but then, like, we're at less than 2%. And, like, they tally up again, and Sanders takes the lead again. And I'm like, okay. And then the results go dark, right? Like, everything just disappears after Sanders comes back ahead. And so, like, days later, they start reporting again. And I'm watching the official tally on the New York Times website. And again, it's like they're getting like 62%, 71%, like 80%. And again, like Buttigieg in the lead and like Sanders behind. But like every time they report more results, it's like creeping closer and closer. They get to like 99%, or they get to like the last like 3%, right? It's like 97%. And it's like, oh, Buttigieg like a whole like 1% ahead, right? A pretty narrow, it's like 1% ahead. Okay. Then they report like 1% more and it closes entirely. Sanders 0.1% behind. Like so closely tied that it doesn't even matter, but they only reported just enough to not put Sanders in the lead. And then the fucking DNC chair, Tom Perez, he's like, you know what? Actually, fuck this. We're re-canvassing the whole state. Like right at that very moment. Like the places where delegates were like largely unreported were like Sanders heavy districts like Des Moines.
Yeah.
So wait, one more thing, and then yesterday, like the DNC puts out a notice that's like, okay, we're re-canvassing the state, we're recounting, but we're not going to change the results. Like whatever the wrong results are, we got. We're just going to go with them. We're going to recount to see what we did wrong, but we're not going to fix the results.
I said to honor the integrity of the election.
Yeah.
How is there integrity if you messed the entire thing up? That doesn't make sense.
There's like graph. I got a graph here. Someone in my on Twitter, someone posted this fucking image showing how like. Okay, because, like, independent sources totaled up, like, how many errors there are in the caucus and, like, which candidates they favor. So I just think, yeah.
Oh, boy.
Guess what the takeaway here is. Wait.
I bet our boy, the mayor, is going to be looking real rosy here.
So look at the errors. Ones to the right are detrimental, ones to the left are positive. Overwhelmingly, the errors in calculations disadvantaged Bernie and advantaged Buttigieg.
Ben, it's a statistical fluke.
I know. I better take my fucking tinfoil hat off, right? I'm just being a conspiratorial Bernie bro.
This is a fucking Jeffrey Epstein level, like, oh, obviously, like, I already know, I've heard that, like, Pete is, like, somewhat involved with the CIA. App that was made.
Pete is CIA. And, yes, and that's not even the half of it, because the app that failed, that allowed for so much gross incompetence and obvious, like, corruption to take place, Pete Buttigieg funded it. The app is called Shadow Incorporated, or the company is called Shadow Incorporated. The CEO is a Buttigieg guy. Her husband is like literally works for Pete. So this is cool. Okay, and you know what? That's fine. One rigged primary. That's fine. Whatever. It's no big deal.
Right.
But the real fucking tragedy here is that they did it. They released the data in such a way, like they timed everything perfectly, so that like they never have to say Sanders is in the lead. CNN can fucking spin it to say, oh, Buttigieg maintains narrow lead going into the New Hampshire primaries.
They announce a bit of Sanders, and then immediately Pete is, you know, more data to show that Pete's in the lead, so there's no like news cycle where Sanders could be at the top.
Yes, with 0% data reported, Pete goes on Twitter and says, "Thank you everyone for this victory in Iowa." Declares victory without any fucking data.
You know, I listened to some of those things. I thought that because like everybody went on to like announce victory.
Bernie did it later. Bernie did it later after the votes were tabbed. Bernie declared victory because he did win the popular vote by 6,000 votes. Bernie won the popular vote. And they have like an equal. They have an equal amount of delegates, I think. And if they don't, like it's like because of 0.1%. It's like totally stupid.
I mean, whatever. If you're Bernie at this point.
So this all happens. Bernie gets rat fucked by the DNC. Pete is CIA. Wall Street Pete is a fucking cheat. That's what's going on. And you know what? It's looking like it worked. It's looking like controlling the narrative like this has worked. And Pete is surging in New Hampshire now, where Sanders was the favorite to win. So
Wow. He can't beat Bernie in New Hampshire.
Know. Polls conflict. Polls have been showing conflicting things. At worst, polls have shown that Pete is like close to Sanders. Some still show Sanders with a substantial lead. Mm. Apparently, this morning Pete had like the biggest turnout for his rally because they're all doing rallies today. Mm. Supposedly, according to social media, Pete got the biggest turnout. So this has got me. This has been like the worst week of my entire life. This is a fucking nightmare, right? I don't like Pete. Pete's bad, and I was mad about it, and I was thinking like, man, this is shaking. I was all for vote blue no matter who. Like, I love Bernie, but I was still gonna swallow my pride and like vote Hillary or whatever. And then this happens, and I'm like, oh, they're just cheating, and I'm really mad.
They literally cheated provably last time.
And once it's the first fucking, not even a primary, a caucus, and we're already fucking cheating. It's obvious, but fucking moms at home don't follow Twitter. They're not looking up graphs like this, right? They're just like CNN says, yeah, wow, Pete narrowly beat Bernie, and they slurp their fucking wine on their couch as their husband fucking fucks the secretary, what a nice young gay man, you know, he looks like a politician, doesn't he?
He does.
So I was worried about that, but like. Then yesterday, I get fucking scared, right? I get fucking scared because I didn't even know this about Pete. Apparently, Pete wants mandatory military service for every kid in America.
Like in the Boy Scouts?
Graduating high school. No, like you serve in the military for a year when you graduate high school.
Like Israel or something.
This is like front. Yes, like Israel. Okay. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah,
it says on his website, we
want to establish an expectation for mandatory service. I didn't know this. I see this and I'm like, oh my god.
Maybe he means like community service. You know, you'd pick up some trash on the weekend a little.
No, that
even that I obviously
military
hate,
means
but,
military.
You know.
I mean,
well, let me. You want me to?
It could just be an office job, but it's still like. In the realm of things you wouldn't want.
I certainly agree.
Like mandatory anything. Yeah.
Let me try and find the graphic. Sure, sure. Here it is. Pete's vision. Let's read about Pete's
vision. I can't wait
to
see our future president's vision, personally. I'm looking forward to it.
Oh boy. Hold on. Sorry, I gotta read this and judge for yourself, I guess. Our intention,
so this is from his website, it looks like.
Yep. Our intention is for this proposal to create a pathway towards a universal national expectation of service for all 4 million high school graduates every year, such that the first question asked out of every college freshman or new hire is, where did you serve? A new generation of American youth, bound by mutual service and sacrifice, aware of the common values that bind all Americans, influenced by the experience of da-da-da-da-da.
Blah, 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 yeah.
Okay, and this is apparently from a. Okay, apparently you have to sign up for his email list to even get to this part of his website.
I see.
So this is where we're at, people. This is where we're at. We've got this fucking rat, this little fucking rat fucker, surging in the polls because the media, I guess,
because
just hates Bernie so much.
Yeah, yeah.
And because
we need Bloomberg to save us, honestly. Bloomberg, come in here. Just, you know, get Pete out of here. Let's go.
It's exactly the same sort of stuff that happened in the fucking Jeremy Corbyn in the
yeah.
the most recent election.
Really?
Yeah.
Where he lost sure. a lot because mm-hmm. everyone like piled on. As soon as the election had started, it was all about shitting on Jeremy Corbyn as much as and as hard as possible constantly. Okay. And not shitting on the opposition quite as much. And, you know, the media does what the media does. They do what they're told by whoever's got the power. And it's like...
okay.
I mean, Jeremy Corbyn, like, arguably wouldn't have been that great a leader. But the demonstrably, like, you know, he was demonized beyond what he was actually like.
They called him, like, anti-Semitic and stuff, it's, right?
Yeah, yep. it's like, around. It's all about, when the election happens, it's all about lying as hard as you can, as loudly as you can, for just long enough for people who don't actually pay attention that much to get some sort of idea in their heads. And then when they go to the polls, you win, you know.
Hell they, yeah.
That's just, you know, that's how it is.
If it wasn't for the graph that you posted, Ben, I mean, okay, this is all still, in theory, explainable simply by incompetence.
Nate,
like, sure,
Nate, look
it's
at
possible.
That. Look at the fucking... Look at them. Look
I mean,
at the difference.
The fact that, I mean, you're not wrong. You're not the...
In theory... Yeah, Nate, in theory, you fucking... remember when, like, Dr. Manhattan is, like, holding yeah. up the ring and he's like, I've yearned to see a quantum event wherein, like, a molecule spontaneously turns into gold. In theory, that's explainable by random chance.
I guess you're right. Okay, real quick. At the bottom, I see this negative 2 on the left to the 3 on the bottom. What do those numbers indicate? I see SDE
that is,
errors.
That is S. Okay, you got your people show up to vote, right? With their where they stand, like which group they stand in, and then they realign into like a new like grouping for where they're going to vote. Those numbers are tallied, and through some sort of mathematics that I don't know what it is. A number is the SDEs are calculated.
Okay.
And that is basically how many, like, state internal delegate, the SDEs, I don't know what SDE stands for, but it's like these state internal delegates that are going to, like, get basically how many points from that precinct they win based on the vote. And then those points get like, all added together from all precincts. And then those point totals are, again, used in some weird math that I don't understand to determine how many final, like, actual state delegates go to the primary vote. Understand?
Okay. I think so. I thought at the bottom that would have been, like...
SDE is, like, an intermediary calculation between actual vote and delegates assigned.
When I looked at the bottom,
so
I saw numbers
larger,
that...
So, areas in a state or whatever to account for, like, the differences in size or, like, the ruralness...
Yeah, like how the Des Moines precincts got like way more SDEs because they're like much more heavily populated.
Sure.
So as you can see, because of this, and the race was incredible. Remember, there was like a 0.1% difference. Buttigieg.
So he basically should have won. I mean, if there wasn't massive incompetence, clearly this is the takeaway.
Buttigieg
if...
gained more than. Two and change whole SDEs, and Bernie lost almost 3.
I have one other question about this. I don't know if this is true or not. I heard that Buttigieg had basically gone all in on Iowa, so it was expected that he would perform well, even though nationally he's doing not well, because he specifically focused in Iowa with the hope of like getting some snowball effect. Obviously, it doesn't explain the errors.
I guess
here,
it worked. He, you know. I mean, by any metric, he did outperform. Like, he was not, like, the polls I was seeing had him getting like 15%. It was like the polls seeing were like Warren and Biden, Sanders and Biden tied for front, and then like Warren and Pete like pretty, like trailing pretty far behind in third place. I don't think anyone expected, because if we fixed all these errors, he's definitely like in a strong second place, which is really bad like and upsetting. Even that alone would be cause for alarm. The fact that they cheated to put him over the edge and be able to say, "Oh, Pete won Iowa," that's a problem. Anyway,
so
I'm seeing
that headline.
That's all they want. That's all they want. And then I'm seeing them trending on Twitter. I'm seeing, it's like, oh, wow. Okay, people this morning are saying huge crowd for Pete at his rally this morning. However, at the they had an event last night where like all the candidates came out on stage and talked, and while Pete was out, the crowd started chanting "Wall Street Pete, Wall Street
I heard
Pete,
about that.
Wall Street Pete," which is great and all. Trump didn't get impeached. Who could have seen that coming? Did you see Nancy Pelosi ripping up the speech?
Tear up the paper. Yeah. I don't know. People are mad. Who cares? Whatever. She's mad.
Oh,
it's fine.
Who's?
It's fine.
Well, okay. I'll give my fucking people on Twitter. Oh, who's that one? That one fucking pundit is like this. This is the most disgraceful event that's ever been seen in Congress. And it's like, someone replied like, some senator or congressman like literally like physically beat the shit out of another one.
I heard
for,
about
like,
that.
Saying slavery was bad.
Well, there was like a motion to abolish slavery, and a man, he got caned nearly to death by his fellow senators on the floor of the Senate, like 150 years ago or something.
But this is just
this
beyond
is
the
one.
Fuck. Okay, Trumpites and conservatives are such fucking coward snowflakes that they cry and whine about tearing up some paper. But also, fuck Nancy Pelosi. This is like bullshit performative politics and means nothing. Oh yeah, slay queen, slay.
Sean tweeted
like Nancy Pelosi will vote for Trump's third term, but everyone will applaud because she'll give him the finger while she like ollies out on a skateboard or something. I was like, yeah, that's about right.
I mean, on the whole subject of this whole thing, I mean, obviously the line from Trump and his allies is going to be like, I mean, what's the real embarrassment here? Like tearing up, or like, what's the real disgrace? You know, fucking like impeaching the president over, you know, things that arguably they think didn't, well, at the very least, they knew nothing would come of it. They got Mitt Romney's vote, bro. We did it. We got bipartisanship.
They were never gonna, man, it's fucking wild how it's just like Democrats, except for Mitt Romney, who went pro impeach, and Tulsi Gabbard, who should have voted impeach, but for some reason declined to. It was completely partisan. Like every Democrat voted impeach, every Republican voted not in both fucking houses. It's fucking wild.
Yeah, it's
so
true.
Yeah, it was obviously never gonna work, and it was a waste of time, and it's just emboldened Trump's support, and they go, ha, four more years, he's so fucking powerful. Oh, fucking suck my dick, Daddy Trump.
It's mostly just sad that I don't know, things are in that way, but whatever, I haven't said that a million times. I guess we'll get over it eventually, I don't know.
Well, it's a nightmare. What else was I gonna say? Oh, yeah.
How do you think this bodes for the Democrats' election coming up, Ben? What do you think?
It's real bad. Mm-hmm. It's real bad. I mean, even if Pete were the nominee, he wouldn't win. Sanders is the only one who might win, and I'm not 100% sure. Mm-hmm. If it came down to Sanders v. Trump, it might be a coin toss. Anyway, I'm in physical pain. I'm literally in physical pain, like, every day, because I'm so fucking worried about it. I'm, like, following it constantly. I can't sleep. I can't eat. My back hurts.
When's New Hampshire? That's the next one, right? New Hampshire? When's that?
New Hampshire... Well, listener, by the time you hear this, it will have already happened because it's on Tuesday, and there will probably be a whole new cycle of rat fuckery and cowardice from the DNC and these fucking drooling MAGA fucks will clap their hands like seals and bleat. And it'll be fucking amazing.
Speaking of seals, monk seals are extremely protected. They're an endangered species in Hawaii. I just got a sick pic with one on the beach this morning.
Wow,
you gotta
Nate,
check this out, man.
That's
you've
so great for
this.
You. I'm
it's
so
really
happy.
Good.
I'm so that I'm so glad for your seal picture.
There was also a dog wearing goggles.
No,
what?
Wow,
yeah,
that's...
dude.
Cool.
Did you push him into the ocean?
You know, we thought he might be going skydiving or something sick like that. Turns out, we asked the guy, or Michelle did, he's just German Shepherds, which he was, are sensitive to UV light, so he just wears these cool goggles, like
that...
a Digimon main character, to protect his eyes from UV light.
You didn't get very close
light.
To him.
Look at that fucking lump.
See that sign? See that sign right there? You are not allowed to, by state law, get any closer to those fucking seals. than you are there. Although,
then that's fine.
Well, really, you're not allowed to touch them. You're not allowed to touch them. But these, okay, I'm going to call them these island autists, get so up in their fucking shit about, don't touch the turtles, don't touch the seals. I'm not going to touch it. I'm just going to pet it. I'm just going to give him a little pet, and he's going to love it. It's going to be sick. He's going to thank me. So don't freak out. But yeah, he's snoozing. We went to there's a little island out Chinaman's Hat. Yep, it's called Chinaman's Hat is the name of this little island.
That's that like black thing sticking out there?
No. This is it's on the north. This is facing the south side. It's on the north side of the island, I think. We got kayaks yesterday. We paddled out, and when we got out to that island, first of all, we nearly died on the way back because the winds picked up to an insane degree. And one of our group fell over in their kayaks and were being pushed towards the rocks. And like one of our the guides had to jump out of his canoe, swim over, and save them from like dying. And he came back with like a huge fucking bloody mass on his leg because he took the hit to like save him from the rocks. It was fucked up. But it was also awesome, and I loved it, and it was totally cool. But on the beach, on Chinaman's Hat, there was just a big old seal just hanging out on there, and I got way closer. I was probably, like, I don't know, maybe 10 feet away. But you're not allowed to touch him. Everyone gets way on your case about it. But he was cool. He was cool.
Natives do or tourists do?
Natives, which I understand. It's they're very into conservationism.
These fucking idiots trying to conserve their precious wildlife.
It is embarrassing, frankly.
Get over it.
There's chickens that wander around everywhere here, and I think they're also protected. Although I know they're delicious. So, it's a good time.
Not protected forever.
Oh, one last thing. I wake up today and I see hashtag Antifa terrorists trending on Twitter because
what are they up to these days?
Because I guess the KKK are having a rally in Portland or something, and and Antifa's there, and fucking Andy Ngo. Andy fucking Ngo is there to post some like
the rats.
to post some like totally ambiguous footage that he claims is like, oh, Antifa pushes a woman in front of a car, and like it doesn't even really look like it, but like he says it, so I guess
guys,
we better
forget Antifa. We gotta talk about the real scourge. I saw a video this morning of furries bashing, I believe it was a Chrysler vehicle, apropos of nothing,
not Chrysler, not one of our good American companies.
I heard something like animal
are they American? I don't know.
I think they are. They were just chanting like something about like animal testing. I don't know. Does Chrysler do animal testing? I don't know. I'm unaware, but they're the real scourge. I mean, they were just in full fursuit, two guys bashing a car.
Did they have like claw like weapons in their paws?
No, they were just holding a baseball bats in their disgustingly human like hands, which was a problem.
No,
for me.
Oh, not human hands.
No commitment.
Yeah. You got to at least like gaffer tape the bat to the paw and swing it around.
Hold it in your mouth and swing it like Sora in the Lion King world.
Like Zorro.
Oh, speaking of Sora, I'm definitely going to do a picture where I pose like Sora from Kingdom Hearts 2, the title screen. We're standing in the water with a popsicle in his mouth. Look for that on my Instagram soon. Instagram.com/bestestguyever. I'm thinking about, I want to commit to this. I want to mod a copy of Kingdom Hearts 2 and play on an emulator where I use whatever image I produce in this way as the title screen. Oh, I love Kingdom Hearts.
I don't understand the plan.
I'll show you.
To take a picture doing the pose and then put that in the game so when he plays the game, he sees himself.
Just on the
and
title
he says,
screen. I'll go, ooh, it's me! And then I can distribute this as, like, you know, the good version of Kingdom Hearts 2. The vastly improved. I'll be elite modder, just like Econ. It'll be great. I bet I could make that happen. I know stuff.
You know, speaking back on like the whole lefty stuff, I have been
Antifa's the good guys, people. Antifa is the good guys. Figure it out.
Yes, I mean I have been watching a lot of specific BreadTube, Philosophy Tube, and ContraPoints. I've just been like playing Dark Souls and then having that on in the background and learning all about these things, such as, I forget all of them, but Antifa was one of the things that they talked about. They talked about how Antifa... I mean,
was it a ContraPoints video?
It was a Philosophy Tube. But like the...
Let's talk about it.
I mean, I've watched so many of these videos that they sort of bled together and I can't like pull specific lines out, but the, you know, I get the gist, I understand that it's the false equivalency that is the problem.
It is like it is the false equivalency that is the problem. It's true.
There's you know, there's a lot more nuance and interesting thoughts in the videos, but it's just sort of
ghouls on Twitter. These fucking Andy Ngo types who just make money. God, the video of someone quote pushing it's he says Antifa pushes a woman in front of a car, right? In the video, it's not clear who pushes her, and there is a car on the road, but it's like pretty far down the road, and it's not even moving that fast. And like, the woman seems annoyed to have been pushed, but not like afraid for her life at all. So, but whatever. The comments are just like hundreds and thousands of people being like, attempted murder. Where are the police? Why doesn't the mayor crack down on these terrorists? Like, if I were there, I would have shot them. Hashtag concealed carry.
It's just so weird, because, like, there was this bit where he was saying, like, they use the fact that Antifa wears masks for very clearly useful reasons so that they don't get attacked themselves later. And
by people like Andy Ngo, who will fucking dox them.
And it's like, it's not necessarily an indication of violence. You just, you know, you want to protest something and you don't want to get backlash for it. And it's not illegal to wear a mask. But he was making the comparison that, like, riot police wear masks and they do, you know, they wear black. And it's like the things people are talking about Antifa for being, like, terrorists, bullies, horrible people, the police as well, which, you know, I think we can all agree that they're kind of a lot worse in every way.
Dude, ACAB. The Munchie, so I'm on Munchie's Audible subscription, and he got me to read, we talked about this book Debt, the First 5,000 Years. He told me to listen to it. I did. We both think it's fucking great. And I have talked about, I think I've mentioned before that I've been meaning to read this book called Bullshit Jobs, which is about how, like, in America, a lot of the jobs that exist are basically just, like, fake and made up and unnecessary and do not exist to, like, serve any material purpose. They are just, like, a product of, like, corporate bureaucracy. Mm-hmm. And Munchie's like, hey, I got another book by the debt guy. And it's about, like, apparently this debt guy, he was, like, one of, like, the organizers for the, like, Occupy Wall Street movement. And it's, like, about that whole, it's the whole experience of, like, what the Occupy Wall Street movement was about. It's called, oh, fuck, that one's called Democracy something? It's called Democracy. I forget the full title. It doesn't matter. But it turns out this guy, David Graeber? Joshua? I think it's David Graeber. This is the guy who wrote Debt. Is the guy who wrote Bullshit Jobs, which I have not read yet, but it's on the list. It's next on my list. I'm going to listen to it. And he also is the guy who did this. He was this, like, front runner in the Occupy Wall Street movement. And he's my new hero. Like, what a fucking Chad. He's doing it, man. He's doing it. Boy. I
just want to quickly say, I didn't mean, like, that, like, all police are worse in every way. Like, it's the hypocrisy that the people who are complaining about Antifa don't complain about the police for doing the same things to people that they don't like minorities.
It's pretty appalling. People calling for, like, Antifa to be labeled, like, a terrorist organization and stuff. They're so fucking scared. These conservative types, these gun-wielding maniacs, are so fucking scared of these thugs, these thugs, they're demonstrably so much less violent. They have, like, right-wing extremism kills, like, hundreds of people a year. Antifa's never killed anyone. They basically just throw milkshakes and, like, squirt silly string at people, which is kind of, like, sad, but it's true. Like, that's what they do. Maybe a window gets broken once in a while. There was that one guy with the bike lock. Okay, everyone's like, "Oh, that one guy with the bike lock." Okay, that was bad, right? Nobody likes that guy. Everybody fucking hates that guy.
Yeah, the thing that really strikes me about, like, Philosophy Tube and ContraPoints, aside from, like, their reasonableness in tackling these issues and not, you know, they appear on the outside to be like, "Oh, outlandish, lefty, stupid idiots," but. Of, like, the things they say are like, oh, you know, they win people over, clearly, because I didn't used to be a right-wing guy, but, yeah. like, I had been conditioned by seeing that side of YouTube more, and not seeing the left side of YouTube, that the types of people that are stupid look and sound like, you know, left people. So if you ever see or hear a lefty idea sort of thinker, then you should immediately think, oh, what an idiot. What a social justice warrior. But going into the videos, they're so well produced that they draw you in, and then you listen to them, and the things they say are just, oh yeah, like, I get it now. I understand that I was not really thinking about anything before. I was just making judgments on people.
There was the anti-feminist crowd, or like the crowd that was like there to criticize like crazy feminists on YouTube for a while. They were kind of like overlapped with like the atheist YouTubers, right? Or like the rational skeptic types. And like back in the day, that was one thing, but like a lot of them, not all of them, but like a lot of them like went on to like do this weird morph into these like conservative reactionary like people that have these like it's because like Shuon Head
I know of her. I never really watched her videos.
She's the girlfriend of like Armored Skeptic, who was also one of these like rational dudes.
I always thought his icon, like his avatar he uses, was really goofy.
It's very
suit and the knight
very
helmet.
Stupid, very stupid. But like I like she was one of these like, oh, look how dumb these feminists are. But like, I don't know. I think lately she's been kind of like, oh, you know, I kind of think maybe I went a little too hard in that direction before. Like now she's like a big Bernie supporter and stuff, and she's like, I don't know. I think she's fine. I think she made mistakes, sort of like, but she's fine now.
I don't think she's really changed much of her political opinions, but she just does like Bernie, and that happens.
It's the thing.
By the way, I would use as a moment to show that perhaps some of these people with opinions, you know, more on that side, are more reasonable than you might think
they
at first.
It's really just the fact that back in the old days when the internet was new and we were discovering through YouTube just random people and their thoughts, it was novel. And you would find somebody saying something crazy, and then you would, you know, find it and mock it. Mm-hmm. And if it was really stupid, you would, it sort of became profitable to do that. And that became a whole sect of YouTube, is to find people. And it just so happened to be, like, feminists were saying things that could be easily taken out of context. Or not. You know, there are people who say stupid things who are feminists. And so that became that whole big thing. And now it's, you know, similar stuff on the left, but it's through progression through, like, YouTube and culture, and, you know, popular culture of internet stuff, a lot of people, I think, have realized that it's, you know, it's easy to point and laugh at a certain group, but nobody is, like, free from criticism. Like, every group has problems, and so to really get, you know, really smart about things and be an intelligent man with max manner, like, max intelligence, you need to realize that people you
like
may
me.
Have enjoyed were, you know, have perhaps, like, incorrect or problematic or I hate words. This is why I don't speak so much.
In a society where everyone, this is increasingly how we are, where we're all damned for our, you know, everyone makes mistakes. And if the damnation threshold is getting lower and lower and easier to cross, literally everyone will be, I mean, you can find and mock, choose a person, pick a random person on the planet. I guarantee you, like, you can cancel them online. I have no doubt whatever measures you
want. This is the sort of thing.
Yeah.
Like, I kind of cringe at the same people who, like, call JonTron a white nationalist racist who is completely evil, because they don't know...
Overstating the case.
Everything. Yeah. They're overstating the case. They're playing into a thing.
Mm-hmm.
JonTron obviously is not, like, you know... Well, not obviously, but, like, the things he said in that thing, that live stream, were stupid and wrong. And he apologized for that, and he probably was just sort of misled by being, you know, he hadn't found the left side of YouTube and realized that there was a different way to think about all this stuff.
I think it's because he's a gamer and he probably just hung out in fucking gamer spaces. And, like, gamer spaces. Probably. I mean, this was like a... I was going to say, like, I can understand. I can... It's not hard for me to understand why, like, back in the day, people really love to, like, tear into, like, crazy feminists and things like that. And, like, I get it, right? But then that turned into Gamergate, and Gamergate was bad. And now we're living in a post-Gamergate world, and it's not funny anymore. Now it's got, like, now it's serious. And some people, people leaned into that, and some people, like Shoe on Head, were like, hold on, this has gone a little too far. I didn't mean for it to go where it went.
Yeah. I have a universal problem with all... You know what YouTubers are like? YouTubers are like... You know, there's a giant seaport town. It's like a ship manufacturing plant, which is obviously highly productive, and people work there. Like, YouTubers are like the surface population of, like, divers who, like, wrecks happen and, like, other people have made cool stuff. And divers do cool stuff. They go down and they find treasures, but they're not, like, the main industry. They're surviving off of, like, plumbing the depths for what other people have done. And a lot of the times that can be valuable. You can find some really important stuff down there. But it is a surface industry that exists on the back of lots of other stuff. And to that end, I think there's lots of incentives...
YouTube is stomach acid, as DeVu once said.
Oh yeah,
is that what you're getting at?
Yeah, but I was gonna say that, like, the issue I have that sort of relates to that is that, like, those divers, to stick with that metaphor, they have such an incentive to, like, play up their discoveries and to make everything seem like such a big deal. And more to the point, like, when it comes to actual discussion of whatever topic's going on, there's such an incentive to escalate and flatten ideologies on any side, such that, just take your extreme right-wing stuff. You got full-blown Nazis, I don't know, like, white supremacists, then, I don't know, you're getting into maybe, like the, even this, I mean, you could argue how strong these are, but, like, the Proud Boys, then maybe, like, Second Amendment strong guys or whatever, then, like, general conservatives, and then, I don't know, you're getting more to the middle of people. Like, you could choose, and I to me, it seems like this happens a lot, and on the other side as well, calling them commies or whatever, like, you could pick a guy on the early end of those rungs and just flatten them up to Nazi, because that's, like, all the way. And to me personally, on any side, when I see people call Bernie a commie, it frustrates me as well. I hate all that is a loss of signal and a loss of information. And this is why I so famously said back in the day on the PCP, I hate the spoken word. It is so easy. I just wish we could have direct data transfer between brains so that you can't do that sort of stuff.
Like that fucking magic thing in Digi's light novel.
Does he have that? I haven't checked it out yet.
Did you listen to that? It's the chapter two. Is like he explains.
Oh, you mean of Road to Radcon?
No. Of course, you should check out Road to Radcon chapter two, but
I have not checked out any of his new light novels.
Kusomega, that one.
It's very clear, like, this is the perfect thing. I would love to have this.
Says the autistic
person who can't, like, socially relate to anyone. It's the magical ability to project thoughts into the minds of people without any sort of speech, and you can perfectly, like, the more powerful you are in that magical ability, the more succinctly and perfectly you can relay that information. And there's, like, a few paragraphs in a chapter where, like, this is explored, and it's, like, people are having thoughts and they're all, like, getting things done, like, super efficiently because nobody has to actually talk to each other.
That's good. And that's good.
It's great.
There is a really interesting video by Innuendo Studios about, what was that game? The Beginner's Guide. You guys know that game, The Beginner's Guide?
Yes.
I do not.
The Beginner's Guide is made by the guy who made, what's the one? Stanley Parable. The guy who made Stanley Parable, which was a huge hit, came back and he made this game called The Beginner's Guide, which is the Beginner's Guide pretends to be the conceit of The Beginner's Guide is that what you are actually playing is a series of unreleased, like, unfinished games by an unknown developer called Coda. And this guy who knows Coda, who, no, oh, fuck, I forget his name, Davey Reedon, is the guy who made Stanley Parable, and supposedly in the game, the real life Davey Reedon is walking you through these unfinished games and explaining to you like what he thinks they mean. And it's just like him, like being like, "Yeah, let's delve into the mind of this guy, of this unknown like creative genius that I that I know called Coda," but it like it's actually like not that. It's like a fictional story.
Right. Right.
But yeah. Anyway, but anyway, there's a really good video by Innuendo Studios about it in which he talks about like how, in explaining what he thinks the game is about, he like goes back and explains like the theory of like language and authorship, and he talks about how like when someone describes something, they translate like information in their head into like a shared language, and then you take those pieces of language and decode it. But like the image that you put together in your head is assembled from like your experiences with those words,
right,
and it's going to be different from the other person's experiences with those words, and so on and so forth. And it's a great video.
I was watching a Razor Fist was playing through BioShock 1, and obviously he's a big right-wing guy, but he's like, you know, I think one of the problems with a lot of people is that when Ayn Rand was writing, English was her second language, and when she used the word selfish, like, for example, that didn't quite convey the meaning that she meant to the English audience. I don't know, I never really thought... I thought she was trying to take back the word when I read Atlas Shrugged and stuff back in the day, but,
yeah,
I mean, it's the same sort of thing. It has a very negative connotation in the West, and probably due to our Christian roots and whatnot.
But, Atlas Fugged.
Atlas Fugged. Oh, he has his heavy balls he bears atop his shoulders that he must relieve himself of, but
I was afraid I was going to spend the entire episode raving about the fucking Iowa caucuses, but don't worry.
Mm-hmm.
Next episode, I'll be back to talk about New Hampshire.
New Hampshire.
Since it will have already happened, let me just preemptively say, fuck the DNC. Bernie got rat fucked in Iowa and New Hampshire. It's time to riot.
Yeah. Do you recommend?
It seems like time to riot.
I guess vote Bernie would be Ben's like, prescription. I mean, that's
let me. You know what? I've been conflicted. Right. Mm-hmm. I've been conflicted about something. I guess I might as well talk about it here, unless you think it's boring.
Probably,
almost definitely. I was very much like, you know, I should, even though I hate Hillary, I should have voted Hillary in 16. Mm. And I'm like,
That's a tough one.
That's what I've said. And like, because like voting third party didn't accomplish anything. The DNC didn't care.
Yeah.
And like the turnout for the third party was not anywhere close to what it needed to be to make a meaningful difference. And so this time I was like, you know what? Okay, I want Bernie, but like this time I'm vote blue no matter who.
Mm.
But then they start cheating. And then I read this shit about like mandatory military service, and suddenly I'm not so sure if I'm gonna do it. Like
that policy alone, you know, I think that's one of those things
cheating made me like I don't want to vote for them, but I think I was coming down like no, okay, you know what? Even if they cheat, even if Pizza Rat, like if it's gonna
Ooh, Pizza
if
Rat, for, that could be his mascot, the Pizza Rat.
For harm reduction purposes, it's probably better to vote blue no matter who, and also like. Being Bernie, like, okay, the argument for Bernie or bust is that, like, okay, you should be Bernie or bust because people will see that people are Bernie or bust, and it's like, okay, if we don't nominate Bernie, we're going to lose all this support, and, like, that's going to cost us the nomination. Mm. The counter argument is, okay, but if you are Bernie or bust, you're alienating, like, the vote blue no matter who people, and because those people already see the Bernie bros as like, oh, they're bullies online, they were rude to me online, so no health care for poors. That's the attitude, and I hate them.
They put on their
fur
suits
so
and they broke my Chrysler
hard.
That was fucked up, guys.
But I think I was coming down on the side of like, okay, even though I understand that argument, I think that probably in terms of what's going to have the best like material consequences, probably vote blue no matter who is better. But then I read this fucking mandatory military service and I'm like, I don't know. Now I don't know anymore. Now Pete might be worse than Trump, guys. We might have found a guy who's worse. I'm scared.
Trump, he ain't gonna do that. He ain't gonna do that.
He's not gonna do that. No. He might destroy relations with Iran and get us into World War III. But he's not going to do mandatory military service. I don't know.
And look, what do we care about more? If America's economy tanks over 20 years or I personally go to war immediately? I can tell you which I care more about. Leave me alone. Hashtag leave me alone.
And then, of course, there's all these quotes from Pete where he says he wants to put an end to endless war. He keeps saying it over and over again.
Good. That's
so,
no good.
Like, hashtag never Pete.
That's right. That's right. It would be verboten. I mean, does Pete really stand a chance? I mean, Elizabeth, it sounds like she's tanked. Fucking.
There's no way. No, I mean, even if Pete wins the nomination, there's no way.
Oh, you mean Trump. Against Trump? Okay, yeah.
No, against Trump, I don't believe for a second.
The DNC can't rig the entire election. Mm-hmm. They can rig their own party stuff.
That's true. That's true. Yeah.
But, like, nobody actually cares about him.
You guys know that, rats. We're rats. We're the rats.
I don't know that
one. We stalk at night. We sneak at night. We're the rats.
We fuck at night. We come at night. We're the rats.
I mean, if you fuck at night and you come during the day.
I just wanted to make the joke that Pete wants to be the giant rat that makes all of the rules, and we can't.
Yes.
We can't let him do it.
I'm the giant rat that makes all of the rules.
What's this from? What is this? Is this Aristocats?
Now let's find what kind of trouble we can get ourselves into.
I don't know where it's from. It's like from a video.
It's from German985's rat movie video.
you guys know Rat Boy Genius?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. This is why
the other joke that's been going around
there.
Is Rat Boy POTUS.
This is where I make potato knishes. Yeah, my favorite.
My roommates are big into Rat Boy Genius.
He's got an extended body of work.
I myself have not seen the entire oeuvre.
That's too bad.
Rat Boy should pull a Gorillaz and, you know, be a political party that is a fake person. Rat Boy.
That's a great idea.
Pete should, or Rat Boy Genius should.
Rat Boy Genius should, as like the creator of Rat Boy will put Rat Boy Genius as the nominee.
Rat Boy Genius runs as a virtual candidate.
They'd make a music video slash political speech. I mean, of him, and like green screen him into like public events.
We've got Vermin Supreme too. You guys know him?
I've heard of him.
There's so many rats.
another rat. Vermin Supreme is like a fake candidate who like runs an election. He's like this bearded fucking crazy man who wears a boot on his head.
Oh yeah, right. Okay.
I actually saw him like in real life at the straight pride parade like counter protest. He was there just chilling, just taking selfies with people.
Are there these candidates out there? Like, I know that there's some who just like are, they're like, hey guys, if you vote for me, I'm just nobody. I will just do, we'll have like public votes for every issue, and I will simply do like whatever it is that like the democratic, you know, populace wishes me to do. I don't know. I thought those were kind of cool. That's an idea.
Wait,
that's an idea.
What do you mean? Who are you talking about?
Well, I can't think of any names specifically, but I have heard of candidates in the past who think that like the presidency is bullshit anyway. What they want to do is like, okay, if you vote for me, here is my platform. I will decide nothing. I will simply like put out votes to the public on any given issue that comes across my desk, and I will just do what the people.
That seems like it would be really difficult, like since that's not how our like in government infrastructure is.
Absolutely not.
Built.
I mean, you know,
to get people to vote on all of the things. Yeah.
Look how fast China whipped together a bunch of hospitals for the coronavirus or whatever. I mean, that seemed pretty good. Like
there
is
one big hospital.
There is one. Okay, fair enough. But there are advantage to having like an executive who can do thing singular.
Sure.
I don't know if I necessarily would go for that. Government's pretty good. Pretty good government. You know, it's all right. It's doing stuff.
Yeah.
You know, it's
the,
easy.
The one.
Yeah. Go on.
I was going to say the one thing, another thing that makes me really mad. It's like, oh, Bernie's a socialist. I saw a great tweet that was like, I already knew this, but I was reminded in a tweet that like, oh yeah, they said the same thing about Social Security. They said this like, what was the other thing? They said like anything that any public good, they call it socialism. God, and it really makes me mad that Bernie calls himself a democratic socialist, and I'm in his heart. I'm sure he is, but like the policies that he's pushing for, they are not socialist policies. They are just He is basically just an FDR or Truman style Democrat who wants to do something, who wants to create like social program basically on the level of like Social Security.
Maybe Bernie's like, problem it's is that level. Maybe he shares my
and the fact that seen as like a radical leftist position now is just really sad. Super fucking sad, dude. That's how I feel about it.
But what makes you glad, Bendo? What makes you glad in these last few... Yeah, since last week.
What makes me glad? That's a great question. Mm-hmm. Well, I've started working on Slime and Punishment again. I am...
Fantastic.
Finishing up the last few... okay. Because there's going to be, like, a bunch of panels mm-hmm. followed by the video, mm-mm. and I'm working on getting those, like, pre-finale panels done. Mm-hmm. And I'm not going to release them until the finale is ready.
Okay.
But I am putting them up on Patreon for the, like, for my, oh, for yeah, my the $10 people, like, people pledging at the level of, like, getting a cameo mm-hmm. in the thing, like... Yeah, I'm putting them up on Patreon early for those people. And some of them, you know, I don't know. I think maybe it's going in some unexpected directions.
I certainly look forward to it.
shouldn't be too long. I don't know how long the video is going to take. I'm going to try and keep it as simple as I can.
That's wise. That's wise. Yeah.
You know, speaking of that, I haven't finished it as of recording. Mm-hmm. But I hope to finish Chapter 3 of Lord of Ghosts by the time this PCP comes out and is uploaded to Davoo's second channel or whatever.
Yeah,
whatever this is.
Oh, I never tweeted about Lord of Ghosts Chapter 2. I meant to do that.
I think I retweeted some parts.
Shameful.
Yeah, that's embarrassing. Yeah, it is. You're really churning through these chapters pretty fast, which is great.
That is fun.
What I want. Yeah.
Well, he had them sketched, but still. Oh, yeah. Still, it's, that's pretty fast.
I mean, I feel like I've been slowing down a little too much. Mm. I wanted to get them out like every 2 weeks.
Yeah.
But I've been getting like a combination of like, I go down to work and I fall asleep, like, actually, like, why am I doing that? And my wrists are starting to, like, actually hurt.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't know what to do to, like, speed up the recovery. I don't want to not do anything because I need my hands to play video games as well and use the mouse and keyboard.
To jick off. These are important.
Jick off.
All important actions. I mean, I'm envious. I mean, I'm here, you know, relaxing, except for really I fucking hate it because I can't be working on my current project,
playing video games.
That
what
too.
You gotta do.
That too.
I can't be voting in the primary, mm-hmm. guys. No, if my phone. Oh, one more thing.
Yeah.
Fuck what makes me glad. Uh-huh. What makes me mad is I still don't have a phone.
What
didn't you because like, something with the folks? Or?
Yes, yeah. But yes. They had, mom and dad had an extra phone. Yeah. They sent it to me. I took it to the Sprint store yesterday. They were like, nah, it's not a Sprint phone. It's not eligible. Can't do it.
Oh, what? But we're all on Sprint. That doesn't make sense. Maybe I'm wrong. I don't know.
I don't know where they got this phone from, this extra phone, but it's like, nah, it's the wrong type. Can't do it. So I'm still out of phone.
Well.
Genuinely, if I had a phone, this pisses me off more than anything. If I had a phone, I would literally be fucking phone calling, phone banking, and making calls for Bernie. I absolutely would be fucking doing that, but I can't. So instead, I'm just selling Yang shirts and donating the proceeds.
Fair enough. I mean, hey, maybe
I've made like the Yang shirts have raised like $115 or something.
That's good.
And it's all gone. It's all gone to the campaign. It's all gone to Act Blue campaign donations.
I mean, with a generous cut for time and energy, you know, I mean, 50, 20,
no,
80%.
No,
you
all
know.
The all the profit goes. I don't make anything from these Yang shirts.
Hey, speaking of making things for doing stuff, how about that RadCon 4 Kickstarter that's rolling right along?
The RadCon 4 Kickstarter is doing.
Yeah, by the time this comes
good.
Out, how many days will be left?
Oh, we'll have
like
a handful, like three
like
or four.
Four days. Oh god, yeah, this will be the last one. This
that's
will be
right.
the last
this will be,
PCP
this is our
before
last
the Kickstarter
chance.
Ends.
Yep. So we better.
It makes me really mad.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, the Kickstarter has, you know, it did really well immediately, and then it has kind of maintained, like, a pretty steady growth the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
It makes me so mad that we don't have our channel. We do not have the fucking PCP channel where we could be posting updates and like, advertising it more. That's, like, the place we want to advertise it. But fucking Brad Garlinghouse or Ripple or whatever owns it, and we can't use it. And like, I know the Kickstarter's doing good. Like, it outperformed expectations. Mm-hmm. But like, I'm sure it could be doing better if we had our fucking platform.
I have
Holy
no doubt.
Holy fuck!
I have no doubt that that's true. Well, hey, for the record,
it sucks.
We're at
so much.
It does suck. I mean, at this point, I'm starting to think, like, I hope we get it by RadCon, by the time RadCon starts, right? I mean, surely we've got about a month
we're fucked. Nate, I swear to God, we're fucked. They're never going to do it. They're never giving us our channel back. They don't care.
I mean, okay, well, just to be callous for a moment, what about my channel? That 100,000 subs, I mean,
Yours stands a better chance, yeah. But, like, that Mars Reviews guy had 100K, too, and his channel's just gone.
Well, okay, did the people who stole it, they probably deleted it, right? They did that, and now he's maybe working with Google to hopefully recover it?
Yes, he said he's contacted YouTube, and he's hoping to recover it.
Okay, I mean, maybe.
It might come back. It might reappear. I can't guarantee that it won't. Nate, I'm sorry. I hate to say it.
It's my fault.
I really hate to say it. But no, that's not what I'm... No.
Oh,
I don't,
okay.
Look, I'm not mad. Everybody makes mistakes. But I'm saying, I don't like saying it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm afraid that the channels are just gone, yours included.
Hey, baby.
And
maybe
we should probably start, I don't know, just preparing for that.
The reason I haven't done anything yet, okay, one is because it's been a little over 2 weeks.
You've been in contact with YouTube.
Yes.
But the
main thing, and okay, there will be a time where this will no longer be an acceptable, you know, course to continue taking. But right now, they just say the same thing every time. And I do seem to get a human response when I mail them. That's like, yeah, it's a little bit different every time. It doesn't seem like it's a bot. And they're just like, our internal team is working on it. Okay. I get nothing along the lines of, sorry, like, we tried, it can't be done. I've received nothing. And I know that it's in their interest to keep me, like, pacified while they, you know, are figuring this stuff out. But I just feel like there is hope still. I retain hope for these things.
Sure.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know.
If it's not there by the end of February, I have a strong feeling it's not. We're not going to have it back for, like, months and months.
There should be a cutoff point where, like, if we are at a certain point, we need to decide to just make a new... Look, if we get our channels back, okay, great.
Do you know... If we do that, if we start re-uploading videos, we're going to get fucking, like, content matched with our own channel that someone else stole.
That's definitely possible. I guess we could just fight them?
What we should do...
Yeah.
Right. Under the assumption that eventually, it may take a really long time, but eventually the channels will be returned, I think we should make, specifically for RadCon 4, like a channel to do live streams and stuff.
We could do that.
So that it's there.
We should make something for sure. PCP2 or,
the worst
week
of my entire life. I can't fucking deal with it. My back hurts now. It's hurting. Oh, I'm in pain.
Ben, you gotta wake up and do some yoga, brother. You gotta stretch it out. You gotta do some of this gay, girly yoga I've been doing.
Do some girl yoga.
It's great. Yeah, it's great. It opens the chakras. Remember when Guy was acknowledged as the number one taijutsu user by Madara
Fieri?
Uchiha at the end of Naruto Shippuden. Literally me every morning.
How could I forget?
Yeah, it's great. It's wonderful. I have hope. Oh, and you know, the other thing is, I really don't, like, want to make a big deal of, like... I feel like some people have felt like, I haven't seen this a lot, but like, I can't help that since we have a Kickstarter going right now, and we're like, oh God, please help, that some people would think to like, I know what to do, I'll like
we're
back
literally,
the Kickstarter.
We're literally...
But...
Wait, what?
Well, I was just thinking that, like, I don't want people to think that, like, we're just asking for, like, money, because that won't help the problem, like, at all. What I'd love them to do, I don't know, is put some sort of weird arbitrary ghost of, like, pressure on YouTube that will somehow manifest in them getting our channels back faster, which I am dubious at most will even do anything.
We're literally the victims of a crime, Nate.
Absolutely true. 100% true.
This
is real crime. This is real.
Crime has been perpetrated against us, and
yep.
we have been robbed.
Yep. But where are the cyber police? Where are they? Is my question. We need them.
I don't know. They just the police, all cops are bad. They only serve the interests of the capitalist class. So obviously they're on fucking Brad's side.
Yeah.
Cuz he's paying them. He's paying them under the table in fucking Ripple.
I mean, these guys, man, they don't need our channels. It's nothing. They're not getting any
profit
from them.
No, of course they don't.
So little returns. Yeah, it's just, whoever it is, just like some scammer out there who's just like, eh, fuck it. I mean, these people obviously send this out. There's like, I don't know, dozens or maybe hundreds of channels they scammed. Overall, sure, they can make a few $1,000s probably just by doing whatever.
Did you see that screenshot? Like, someone posted it on Twitter and Tom retweeted it about like how like... that other YouTuber called Shad, like, and in his comments, like, oh, so and so got his channel hacked and stolen.
Oh,
and then, like,
a couple
hours later, he's like, oh, I'm so relieved.
Got it back day. Yeah. It's like a China point system, only probably based on like number of subs, like activity on the channel. I mean, I definitely think that's what's happening. No doubt in my mind.
Here's what I think. I think that we fucked up and mismanaged the situation by not
being more
going
urgent.
Fucking ballistic about it immediately, and because it's a fucking nightmare, and I am fucking in panic mode. It is ruining my life. Me.
Fair.
It's all about me.
Fair, right? That's fine.
it is a fucking disaster, and like a worst case scenario type situation. It is fucking Armageddon, and I think that we should have been. I think that we should have just assumed the worst case scenario from the very outset. I think people are not worried about it. Because acting like we're not worried about it. Let me tell the audience right now. I'm fucking worried about it. It's really bad.
But what should they
do? Really fucking bad,
tweet
everybody.
At Team YouTube? Is that the grand play we have?
I mean, yes.
I don't know. What's your fucking grand plan?
I have no plan. I have no solution. I guess at Team YouTube on Twitter.
Nate, I assume you've been retweeting all of the tweets from the PCP Twitter and stuff on your own Twitter.
Most of them.
Like, I feel, because one of them did get a response from YouTube, because we at Team YouTube.
I responded to some from the PCB account.
So, like, any little amount, I mean, we don't know how it works, but, like, the way I was dealing with it at first, because Ben was, like, freaking out a little bit, and I was trying to calm him down, because I just wanted him to be okay.
Well, I'm not!
And now it's gotten worse, and it's like, ah, shit. I fucked up by trying to, like, react with reason.
Well, you know,
because it's YouTube. YouTube is not a good company. They suck. I should have realized it would suck no matter what happens.
Personally, with me, I think one of my issues. Maybe Ben's totally right, and that is the correct response. I have this isn't like a Mumkey narrative where like YouTube betrayed us.
We
personally
fucking are the victims of a crime. We're the victims of a fucking no. You didn't screw up. We are a criminal. Fucking stole our shit.
Okay, I mean you're right. You're absolutely right.
Yeah, that's
a cuck move. Quit
Nate.
Victim blaming. You fuck.
Oh, but I just have no empathy for women who are victimized, and I just have to apply the same I guess shame, and it makes me not want to tell it. It's not that I don't want to tell anyone.
I don't care. I don't care about your fifis, Nate. Yeah. You're the fucking victim, and we're gonna fucking cry about it. Okay.
Fair.
We're gonna cry no matter how good you
feel. The moment I felt hope was lost, I would feel 100% valid to, like, one, I would make a new channel instantly for, like, all these channels, and two, I would probably make a video or two about, I don't know, whatever, I'll probably still do that no matter what happens, but then I would definitely proceed to, I don't think I would even make a big deal, I'd just be like, yeah, hey, here's my new channel, guys, hope you
upload
my videos.
You have to, all right, here's the thing, I think it's easy to use comedy to deal with things that are like, you know,
bad
things like this. Yeah, Brad Garlinghouse. Mm. That's funny.
Yeah.
You know, that's like something we can look back on and laugh.
Yes.
But you don't want to think about how bad things are right now. So let's laugh right now. Mm. And because we're joking about it and being jovial and things, people, I don't think, got the sense that we thought it was a big deal when it started out because we were joking about it. And it's kind of. I mean, I don't know what any, like, our audience could have done differently other than to do more retweets and stuff.
Yeah.
Because that's the only avenue we really have. We don't have the channels.
I mean, if we...
I mean, you've got the link to the person, and that's through email.
If we just step back for a moment, like, let's just say in Fantasyland, let's say hashtag save the PCP, which you should retweet, I suppose, based on all these things, and tweet that out, say blah, 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 retweet
our
stuff.
I have been retweeting everyone who tweets hashtag save the PCP.
If theoretically that hashtag, let's just say magically, became number one on
Twitter. Hashtag panic mode.
Fair enough. If that became the number one Twitter, and, like, people around were starting to talk about it, then, like, I bet YouTube would, in fact. They'd turn their attention, and they'd sort this out in the, you know, half an hour to an hour it would take to give us back our stuff and do all those things. But you know what? You know, I had one other thought on this whole subject. Okay, so for us being here, you feel free to go ahead.
Well, it's really just like I was operating under the same sort of thought. Like, there's no reason to scream and cry immediately.
Yeah.
But you know, because like the likelihood that screaming and crying on our scale for the PCP channel or whatever, like your scale, maybe it would have worked.
Maybe
because you're 100K, but like. The idea that, they're probably not going to do anything if I make a big fuss about it, so I'm not going to make a big fuss, is sort of like, it only inconveniences you for no reason.
You know, just disposition-wise, I'm definitely opposed to, like, being, I don't know, having people having sympathy for me. Maybe it's a personal issue I need to work with. I don't know, but I certainly don't want to be in that position if I can help it. I was going to say that, like, there's another thing that people have said. So there's this guy, The Quartering, who makes YouTube videos about, like, news updates, and it happens that he happens to be on this issue recently, it seems. And I think, like, I checked in his Twitter. His pinned tweet is, like, you know, these channels have been hacked, or, excuse me, something like that. And, like, you know, he seems to be trying to do something to get it dealt with. Okay, the only thing about that is, this is another complicated thing. I don't dislike the man personally. He seems fine.
I do.
Okay, fine. I don't dislike him as a man. He's whatever.
He's a fucking gamer gator.
He definitely is a gamer. There's no doubt about that. So whatever you feel about that, fair enough.
That literally just makes him bad, but whatever.
Okay. Well, on the subject of this, see, here's the thing. I'm sure that in his heart, he feels that, like, doing this can help. And maybe he can spread the word. We were talking about a campaign. Sure. Okay. But I've watched this man quite a bit over the years. I've seen his content. I know what he does. Guys like him, and even to an extent, like Tim Pool, or, I mean, Sargon's been doing it a little bit more lately with his, like, newly stuff.
What a great cast of characters.
A wonderful cast, yeah. And, I don't know, take your pick, any person on any persuasion of any news side, any political thing, whatever, it doesn't matter. Like, I really can't help but feel like these people, does nothing to help anyone, and it's really, like, okay, the thing about The Quartering that makes him unique is that, unlike other people, he will go in and he will say, guys, listen, these channels got hacked, there's only one thing you can do, you gotta share this video, you gotta retweet, you gotta share it around, because this is the only, and I'm like, okay, look, I really don't think that will do anything to help anyone except you and your business personally.
No.
So I mean, maybe if you say just hashtag save the PCP or save the channels or whatever it is. Okay, sure. And again, I don't think it's out of malice, but I can't avoid thinking that, like, and if you're listening to this Quartering one day, I doubt you are, but, like, it's not, I don't dislike you, but this is just so not helpful. Like, I already don't think any of this tweeting at Team YouTube does anything, because let's say our channel gets restored tomorrow, that's almost guaranteed because I put in those YouTube tickets at the very beginning 2 weeks ago.
Well, explain to me how that guy that, like, Shadowverse, the guy who got hacked was Todd of Todd's Workshop. Like,
okay,
did that guy get his channel back in, like, a matter of hours?
Let me see how popular he is. Todd of Todd's Workshop. Let me see here. Okay, this man
is...
Is he a million sub kind of guy? Todd's Workshop. Here we go. I'm seeing 182,000 subscribers. Okay.
So, I mean...
It's not massive or anything. That's...
It is.
I mean,
it's big enough.
It's big.
Bigger than you, but not, like, by, like, a huge amount. He's, like, 180% of...
Assuming
you.
This is the right one. Yeah, no. 1 hour ago, he made a video saying, we're back on his channel. Here, I'll put it in the show notes. So, what... I'm gonna watch this video, see exactly, because I haven't watched this yet, obviously. He's like a blacksmith channel, I guess.
I'm honestly surprised they haven't fixed your channel, Nate, seeing as you are a 100K boy.
I'm a little surprised as well. I don't know why it is. I heard
maybe they look at watch time or something.
We're still in the, that's definitely possible. My channel isn't like the most active or successful 100K one or anything. If we're in the orbit still of 2 weeks, which we are still now, that's fine. These things can take longer. I know of one guy with a smaller channel who took 8 weeks to get restored, but it did eventually happen. So, the two-week thing was just something I had heard. I don't know what it means. Some people are getting fixed. I'm exhausted.
All right, I know that it's sort of like you don't want to look bad. You don't want to look like a guy who's begging for anything because it's not your aesthetic. But, I feel like if there's any chance that it can make the thing happen quicker, then it's nothing to be ashamed of to try if you actually really,
you're right. You're definitely right.
Like, people aren't going to be like, oh my god, is that the guy who got sad when his channel got taken down? that's not going to be a big deal in the future.
I have wondered if I'm emotionally dead inside, because I wonder a little bit why I'm not sadder. And
you're all about those facts and logic. you gotta let your feelings.
I think I kind of feel in my heart I fucked up. I deserved it, because I'm the one who did the mistake.
No, that's fucking stupid.
I know it's
Nate.
I know
that's
I
fucking
know
stupid.
It's stupid. It's just
you're the
a
victim
thought.
Of a fucking crime. We all are. Actually,
all are. Yep.
So no offense, but take your fucking dumbass, woe is me, this is all, I deserve this attitude, and, fuck right off with it. Because, it's effect, like we're all fucking dealing with it.
I care, okay? Yeah, you guys obviously
we're all dealing
don't deserve
with
any
life.
Of this. That's, yeah, it's fair. Okay, well, we're on the same page. We're gonna, literally the only lever of power we have is just to get people to tweet about it. I mean, I don't know. What if
that's
we got
it.
A protest
that's all
in
we
front
got.
Of TY?
So let's fucking get it fucking going before I cry.
Here's a thought. Here's
people?
A thought. What of a public gathering in front of YouTube headquarters, a peaceful demonstration with signs that just say hashtag save the PCP, where we just attempt to get them to a human being with authority to pay attention to the fact that this is happening. I mean,
is that a thing we can do?
It's not illegal, right? I mean, I'm not gonna do that because I don't know how to get. I mean, that costs money to go to California and stuff. But maybe other people would do it. Maybe a lone
guys,
hero.
Guys,
I don't know.
That's
hashtag PCP or I cry. I cry spelled I C R I.
Great, fantastic.
Yeah, that's me. That's what I'm feeling right now.
Okay.
That speaks to my truth.
Well, let's turn this sadness into righteous anger and get people all we can do. At Team YouTube, just keep... I'll just tell people the news. I don't know if I've even told you guys this yet. Team YouTube did message me on Best Guy Ever. Excuse me. I DM'd them all the information about every channel that was stolen in a big spreadsheet. Loved putting it together. It was wonderful. So I can send that out to anybody who wants information on what's going on. And then Team YouTube responded to us at TP Crassinators. And their update was just we'll let you know what we, right now everything is, they seem aware, just nothing has changed. Nothing has been done as far as we can. Maybe they're researching it right now and it's taking them a while.
It.
I don't know.
It would take them no time.
If that's the
at
case,
all.
They should, I emailed them on the BGE email, I think, and just look, I am losing my livelihood here. Just tell me what's being done. If it's in the queue, tell me it's in the queue. If someone's looking at it, if you need any information, I'm in the videos. You will see, I can prove that it's mine, blah, 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 et cetera, et cetera. We just need a fucking human who can help on these things. So it sounds like attention's the game. You forced our hand, YouTube. What else can we do at this point but make your life mildly unpleasant with a large number of
what
hashtags?
What else can we do but occasionally remind you of our existence with notifications
indeed.
On Twitter?
What a nightmare. What a nightmare. All right. Hashtag save the PCP. That's it. Tweet that. Make a Twitter if you don't have one. Fucking get engaged. This is a social media era, you idiot. Get on Twitter. That's what I'm talking about. Ruin your life by engaging in hostile political discourse 24/7 and tweeting about this.
And then and then make calls for Bernie.
There you go.
Please. And be very hot. Be a hostile Bernie bro. Just like yeah. call up fucking Pete supporters and be like, "You fucking neoliberal coward, die."
That's the way.
Don't fucking come to the polls. I'll fucking end you, bro.
That reminds me.
Are you saying? Yeah. Are you saying you call like pizza places to say that?
No, Pete. Yeah, pizza. Yeah, Pete supporters. Pete supporters.
Pizza porters. They carry around the
supporters. Is what I tried to say.
Pizza at the port. And you go off your boat, you get a pizza.
By the way, this is very important.
And you get attacked by Bernie supporters.
I had an important note I meant to read at the beginning. And it was just, in Hawaii, taking it sleazy. But really, that was the Democratic National Convention all along that I was describing. They're taking it so sleazy right now, and I'm jealous.
Tune in to my Twitter yeah. on Friday to see how Ben's angry
incoherent
I am
rage.
About how they rat-fucked my boy Bernie again.
He's got to take that one. We'll see.
Polls conflict, mm-hmm. and like, you know, like who fucking knows? Because the polls didn't anticipate Buttigieg doing as well as he did in Iowa.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but I heard that I think the third one, which they expected Biden to win, was I think South Carolina. Like they expected the black vote to be him.
I think the third one's Nevada and then South Carolina. Okay. I might have them back, but like yeah, non-white people don't like Pete Buttigieg.
Yeah,
Buttigieg has like zero black support, and like he's like only white people will vote for him. So like New Hampshire and Iowa, yeah, maybe, but like Nevada, no. South Carolina, definitely.
Was Nevada, no. I don't know the demographics. Of
Biden,
Nevada, fair enough.
Yeah. I think there's a lot of Hispanic people. Yeah, but like I've looked at the polls and like. Sanders is still number one in Nevada by a pretty wide margin. Buttigieg got a little boost across the board, but like he didn't like soar in Nevada.
I mean,
South Carolina is still like locked in for Biden of all people, and Biden is like dying.
Obama's VP. I guess
Biden's
that you know goes the distance.
Yeah, Biden has a lot of black support for some reason, and he's the favorite to win among people who are just like, why can't we go back to the Obama years?
Why not, I ask. Legalize crime.
So, like, honestly, the one shred of hope... And also, for some reason, Klobuchar is certain... I guess Klobuchar... I watched the debate.
Yeah.
The ABC debate. I'm sorry to bring it back at the very end. She had a pretty strong performance at the debate. The ABC debate was like pretty good.
Yeah.
Like as these debates go, oh my God, I want to talk about fucking Tom Steyer.
I don't know who that is. I have no idea.
Okay. So Klobuchar did well at the debate, and she's getting a little surge too. And I'm happy that Biden's still in it. I'm happy that Klobuchar is in it because they're splitting the moderate vote away from Pete. And like, thank God for Joe. At this point, I'm like, I cannot wait. I cannot wait for Biden to fucking sweep North Carolina just to make Pete look like a fucking idiot.
Yeah.
Just to humiliate him. But anyway, so at the debate, CNN is terrible. The last debate I watched was CNN. It was a fucking nightmare. Mm. This one was ABC, and it was like it was a little annoying, but it was like way less annoying. Sanders did good. Klobuchar did surprisingly good. Biden looked like he was about to have a aneurysm. Warren was not where she needed to be. They hammered Pete on a bunch of like shitty stuff, shitty reasons why he's like kind of racist and like how he like South Bend became like way worse for black people when he was when he was mayor of it. And there's other things too, but like that's the long and short of it. So they hammered Pete on that and like, okay, cool. But like this guy and Yang was there. Yang was there being like, automation, hey, $1,000 an hour. And
there he goes.
Like, yes.
Good old Yang.
Yeah. That's cool. But then this guy, Steyer is so fucking weird. He was kind of the like runaway hit of the night. Like he won the meme vote.
You gotta check this
on whatever it's Steyer. He is an oil billionaire, right?
Okay.
But he's like an oil billionaire, like a fossil fuels billionaire who like at some point in his life he just like decided like fuck this. Like, and okay. It's almost, it seems like it's like a vanity project, just decided I'm just going to be a liberal Democrat and run for president. And like, he's the climate change guy. Even though he's an oil guy, he is pledged, like, the one thing that I'm running on is like climate change. I'm going to be the guy who's like, that's his whole issue. Okay, as far as like running for president.
Is he still an oil guy now? That seems, did he give up his interest or something?
I don't think he is like actively running like oil, like fracking companies now anything. As far as I know, honestly, I haven't looked that much into him. I've looked a little bit into him, but not that much. But he's like, okay. Remember that thing about how Warren, like, Warren wouldn't shake Bernie's hand the last time?
Yes, yes.
Did you hear about that? Okay, well, they're having their argument. She's like, I think you called me a liar on national television. He's like, okay, you want to have that discussion? We'll do that another time. Have it later. Okay, yeah, okay, good. while that's happening, Tom Steyer is, like, behind Bernie, just kind of, like, waiting to get a word in edgewise. Like,
Wanted to say hi to Bernie?
Yes, what that guy.
He was debate.
He's like, "Hi, Bernie. I just wanted to say hi." And he's like, "Yeah, okay." and then in this debate, Steyer's up there like, I mean, he's mostly
Bernie should have been like,
"Sorry,
you have to subscribe to my private Snapchat. That's only for $20."
No, he can't. He can't because Steyer's a billionaire, and he won't let donors.
Oh, they can't follow.
He won't let
Snap.
Billionaires donate to him. So you can't do it. Sorry, Steyer, you're out of the fucking
club. That's too bad.
The whole debate, Steyer's mostly just up there, like standing Bernie, just, like, agreeing with everything Bernie says.
VP. Maybe he's going for VP. I don't know.
I mean, I just think he really likes Bernie.
He clearly seems to like him.
Steyer was so funny the whole time, because my sense watching was that he was just, like, really excited to be there. Like, he's just like, man, I can't believe I'm up on stage with Bernie Sanders and, like, the former vice president. Like, damn, look at me now, Dad. Like,
I can't believe he's the guy who said, I just wanted to say hi to Bernie. I heard that. I was wondering who that was. It's like, it's got to be, like, one of the reporters or something, right?
That's Tom Steyer. And Tom Steyer is, I mean, there are no good billionaires, but Tom Steyer is trying really hard to be, like, less bad than, like, his ilk, even if it's just for, like, his own, like, weird vanity.
Sure,
like,
sure.
Fine. Okay, I'll take it. Honestly, Steyer, solidarity, comrade. we had a bunch of memes. We all watched it in my friend's room, and we had a bunch of memes where people call, like, his supporters the Steyer buyers. But then we're like, oh yeah, I'm a pig Steyer. Like, yeah, I'm in the pig sty.
Yeah,
I'm rolling in it.
That's good shit.
We watched for the first half of the debates. I was in my fucking Discord. Mm-hmm. Just like, we were all just like live, like reacting in my Discord server to two things, just being like, oh my god, can you fuck, oh my god, these guys are, they're fucking hammering Pete, like, fuck yeah. It was pretty good. It was pretty fun.
I guess because, like, whoever's time. The what is it they say, the tall nail gets the hammer or whatever, the squeaky wheel gets the grease,
because, like, Pete was, like, the one who everyone was surprised by how well he did in Iowa. So they're like,
fuck that guy.
He's kind of the one that everyone was going after him on stage. And, like, I mean, thank God.
He has to be fat dicks.
Honestly.
Yeah.
I bet he does suck fat dicks. I mean, he is gay. But,
ew, gross. No thanks.
I know.
Pass,
yeah, I know.
Pass.
I said on Twitter, like, please don't make, like, I want to vote for Luna Mahari, but please don't make me vote for Biden. Yeah, like, no. Honestly, I would, if Biden got the nom, I would, like, grit my teeth and, like, damn it. But I would go and I would vote for Biden. Honestly, I don't know if I could vote for Pete anymore. He's that bad.
I mean, don't know his policies at all. I definitely don't want that mandatory fucking service shit.
The mandatory military service thing is fucking scary. And then his Medicare bill is like, it pretends to be good. He has this, like, line. It's like, oh, not Medicare for all. Medicare for all who want it. And what that basically means is, like, he will do... Okay, the problem... It sounds good, right? It's like, give people a choice. But, like, the problem with that is that if you do... Medicare for all who want it means you don't have to opt... Like, Medicare doesn't work if, like, everybody's not paying into it, like Social Security. Yeah, like, we have progressive tax brackets, like... rich people need to be, like, paying in, like, a proportionally higher share. Because that's how, like, we fucking have... That's how fucking social benefits are done in a civilized society. If you give Medicare for all who wants it, you have to opt in. The only people who will do that are poor people. Rich people will just continue to use their private health insurance because they want to be able to, like, buy priority over poor people in getting health care. And then it won't be... It just won't work and it will collapse. And then it will be even worse because Republicans will see, aha, you see, we tried a public option and it failed. But guess we better privatize even more. That's how they do it.
You propose
a shitty half measure that's designed to fail. It fails, and then they say, aha, public options just don't work. Socialists blown out.
I mean, when you tried
back in my day, we picked ourselves up by our white skin, and we just worked hard for our health.
I worked hard. It was backbreaking work, whipping slaves in the cotton fields. But now here I am, a self-made man. Made it all on my own.
And you know, we have to institute, I mean, you know, as you describe, communism requires everyone to be fully on board, or else the slave subjects will escape to those lovely states nearby. We can't have that. We need everybody to be on board. So let's make it happen. Yeah.
Bernie needs 3 more houses, and we've all got to pitch in.
That's right.
To make that a reality. Like, it's like it takes, it, not me, us. Like, all of us. Mm-hmm. Right?
Us, my houses. Thanks, Bernie. Appreciate that.
Yeah.
Only I'm not allowed. Ah! Yeah.
not me, U.S.
Ooh, us, not U.S. Me. That's good. That's good.
Not me, as in the state of Maine. Mm. Us, as in the United States.
Perfect.
Maine gets fucked. Maine is excised from the union.
All right, voicemails. What do you say? We got a
Let's
bunch of voicemails.
Let's do voicemails. Holy shit!
Okay. Let me see. First, now I think these are gonna. Oh wait, no, we had the issue. Should I try to play it? You think I should give it a shot?
What
from the rhythm bot here, or should I just say fuck it and we'll all
try rhythm?
Okay,
just
we'll
one
try
more
one more time.
Give it a shot.
All right, let me go over here. So as you always know, people, go to the SpeakPipe link down below in the description and leave us your lovely voicemails. And do, if you have a more complicated one, as long as it's good, don't waste your time if it's bullshit. But if you have a longer one, you can always leave a link, like, in the title, as some people do, to, like, a longer one. But I'm telling you right now, if it's not good instantly, I will skip it. All right, anyway, let's try this and see if it works. First one, if it works, this is from... Oh, right, this is just setting the tone for today. It's Brad D. M. Garlinghouse. Who could that be, I wonder? Go, play.
Good.
That,
no,
not,
I can't
no,
do
no,
shit.
No. All right, disconnect.
No,
all right,
it's
right.
Not happening.
Okay, that's all right. We'll just play them ourselves. Okay, let's play it.
That's fine.
Brad D. M. Garlinghouse. Here we go. Count three. 1, 2, 3, go.
You see? I've come to end the voicemails.
Thanks, Brad.
God.
Great.
He just beginning of the voicemails.
Oh,
he just,
shit.
He just takes and takes.
He'll have
he just
no
takes
satisfaction.
And takes.
No, okay, Gib, that's why we played it first, to prove him wrong. You'll never get us down, Brad D. I don't care how many M's. Why did he put the M in here? What's the D M about?
There's probably like some other thing.
Like obviously it's a one piece thing, and that was a one piece sounds, which is good, but you don't get the M.
I think we should exclusively refer to Bread Garlic House in emoji form. Because
good idea.
I was tweeting and there's a bread and a garlic and a house.
That sounds good.
So, like, we should just speak in code. Like, we should never actually type out his name because, like Voldemort, he knows whenever his name is mentioned.
You're
so
right.
We need to speak in code with the bread, garlic, house emojis.
Fantastic. I love it. Let's do
so
that.
This is how we're going to build the resistance.
One loaf at a time. All right. Let's go to the next one.
I don't know why that really got me. Oh,
all right. Next one. Okay. This is good. Let's shit on Digi with amoral. Amoral is a useful word that Digi doesn't use right. All right. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, go.
Digi, you don't use the word amoral correctly. You use it to mean morally bad instead of morally good. But that is what immoral means. Amoral means that it's not on the moral spectrum, which I think is a useful term to have. You could say, like, sexuality is amoral. It isn't good or bad. It just is not even to do with the moral spectrum. So, yeah, not start using it right, because it's cool.
take your pick, which side of the fence I fall mean, on.
This guy is technically right.
Yeah. I don't know whether you would describe sexuality as amoral.
Well, it's like, I don't know.
It's such a made up.
It's like fire, right? Like fire is not
there you go.
Bad.
There you go.
Yeah, that would be an amoral.
Like, okay,
thing.
It burns. It's bad. Oh, but what if it's heating my
like,
house?
Like, sexuality nice. Yeah. Sexuality is like morally good or bad depending on the society in which you live. But fire is fire. Yeah, it just burns.
So there you go.
I don't know. This guy's technically correct, but like, he knows what he means, so I feel like it's a little bit pedantic to be like, eh. Like, I don't know. Digi uses all kinds of words wrong.
He definitely does. I feel like, but do people actually use the word amoral to mean like negatively
moral
or something?
I mean, I always know what he means when he says it in the context that he says it.
I like this guy's definition. He's right. This is a useful word, and I wish it was used correctly all the time.
I think
I like it.
I feel like when someone, you know what? Honestly, I'm kind of curious. Amoral definition. I mean, let's look it up. Okay, amoral means lacking a moral sense, unconcerned with the rightness or wrongness of something. I feel like it's not wrong to. Okay, if you say like, oh, like a murder is amoral, I that would bother me because it's like, okay, you're saying it has no morality, but like I think what you're trying to say is that it is morally bad. But if you say a person is amoral. And it's like they don't care whether something is right or wrong.
Like they're a sociopath
and
or something.
And I think probably it would make sense to infer from that, like, oh, okay, so they do things that are morally wrong because they are amoral and they don't care. I feel like there's an argument to be made here that using amoral in that case is not always bad.
I guess you're right.
Again, this guy is technically correct.
Now, for the true definition, I went over to urbandictionary.com.
Okay, sick.
The first two are boring, yawn, don't care. But the third one, definition of amoral, is simply legalized narcotics. And that's the definition of amoral. Fair enough. All right, moving on.
Legalized narcotics?
Amazing. Legalized narcotics is their third definition.
That's super good. How strange. That's so good for you.
I'm very helped. All right, let's go to the next one. Adulting question mark. All right, let's play this. 1, 2, 3, go.
So Nate's definition of adulthood is providing 100% for yourself, paying your own rent, not living with anyone else, being entirely on your own. So
nothing's 100%.
By that definition, is Ben Saint an adult? I mean, on the podcast at least, we've only ever heard tales of him living with 15 other men in his own squalor, paying as little as possible for rent, and surviving on less than $1,000 a month in a city like fucking Boston, which, how do you even do that, dude? I'm genuinely curious. I need these money-saving hacks that you're using to survive in that shithole city. Please, share. I am genuinely curious. And if you have ever provided 100% for yourself, Ben, please share your experiences. I'd love to know.
Jesus,
I love
Christ.
Nate's little apartment stories and I can relate to it as I've lived on my own since August 2018, and I love it. It's the best thing that ever happened to me. Anyways, thanks for listening, guys.
Hey, buddy, come and fight me in real life, huh? Huh? What are you, not so tough now. You're real tough through the computer screen, huh? You're not so tough when you're facing down the barrel of my fist, fucker. Everybody who comes to my house says, wow, Ben, I expected you to live in, like, a complete shithole, but actually, this place is pretty nice. Like, it's true.
It's
pretty decent. I'm so fucking mad. I don't understand. Is this guy being genuine? I mean, okay, is there something wrong with having roommates, okay? Is this such a fucking problem in 2020, in this economy?
The fact that he correlates being an adult with not having roommates. I mean, Elaine Bennis, the most adult person I've ever known, had roommates in Seinfeld.
I think he's trying to be like, haha, jokey, let's make fun of Ben.
Maybe.
Because of the fact that he brought up Nate's definition of being an adult.
Which isn't even my definition. I mean, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, like, Ben is an adult because Ben runs his own shit. That's what being an adult is, you know. Yeah, you know.
Thank you. Like, I don't know, if you live in a duplex and like you live on one side and another family lives on another, are you not self-sufficient because another family is paying for the other half of the house?
Good question.
Whatever. Okay. No, my shit's covered. My shit's
okay,
fine.
But
by that definition, I am definitely no. I pay for all my own shit.
He does.
So
as far as I know,
I feel like this guy was trying to make a joke, but I'm like genuinely offended.
Yeah, I don't blame you. But I mean, the second half of that. I mean, he said he likes living alone. It's the best thing that ever happened to him. Okay, cool, great. I very much agree. I hate going back to my parents for long periods of time. For like one day, it can be fine. But he's looking for tips about how to live that what's the word, alternative lifestyle.
Wait,
any recommendations?
Was he asking me for advice?
There was a part in there, yeah, where he wanted to minimize costs and whatnot.
I mean, it's like straight up, just like having a bunch of roommates is how I do. It's like my cost of living is
really low. Rent is the number one thing.
Surprise, surprise! You already knew the secret.
Yeah, either you live as a child or you die. That's your two options.
What's more adult than being deceased? You know, like you had your life as a child. Now it's over, and you know, time to move along. All right, enough of that one.
And never eat out.
Never
eat pussy. It's simp behavior. It's simpy.
It is,
no.
Yeah.
Never eat
it's
out.
Simpsons behavior.
Never eat out. Cook all your own food. That's true. Two things.
Buy a giant bag
get a bunch
of rice.
Yeah. Get a bunch of rice, a bunch of beans, and just eat that forever.
I can't believe
honestly,
how cheap rice is. It's great. I mean, you'll be fine. You'll be fine.
When I went off keto, I just ate tons of rice, and I was like, this is delicious.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I could eat this every day, and for a while, I did.
I love rice so much. It's so delicious.
Best money saving tip.
I love Japan, period.
I love curry, Gib.
I
love it.
Yesterday. Okay, the one exception to the never eat out rule. I'm doing this right now. Go to Five Guys, buy some shit, and then while you wait for your order, just shovel free peanuts into the fucking bag.
Yes.
Right? I left
the way.
I left with the entire...
You can definitely cover your costs.
Like, almost the entire fucking, like, paper bag that my order came in, filled with peanuts. I'm still eating them. I'm eating
them
right now.
They're not
going to
stop you. Fantastic.
It's so good. Oh man.
Speaking, I was going to say, on rice
and
all these things...
So that's my secret, actually.
That's Ben's main secret, yeah. Five Guys change the game.
Ben, I love your content. How do you live such a carefree lifestyle? My secret? Free peanuts at Five Guys, my dude. It's all about those free Five Guys peanuts. It's the basis on which I've built my entire empire.
It makes sense. I know I've said this a probably a long time ago, but I might as well say it again. Little known fact, did you guys know that Hawaii is basically Japan 2? That pretty much just is a fact.
Yeah, you have said that.
Oh, but by the way...
It's where all the Japanese tourists go, right?
Absolutely true. Actually, you know, Michelle, while we were here, watched the K-On! Movie.
It's because Ohio sounds like this is like, it's the Hello Island.
That's Japan 3, Ohio. But wherever I go becomes Japan 3, frankly.
Ohio is not Hawaii. They sound so similar.
It's like Kauai. Actually, there is an island called Kauai, but it's spelled like weird, you know, Islander, like K-A-U-A-I or whatever. Kauai or something like that. Still epic. Michelle was here and she watched the K-On! Movie and she was telling me that all the class, because like depending on the class you're in, or the club, because they're in the light music club in K-On!, like all the Japanese, you know, because they're Japanese in K-On!, they all went to Hawaii, which was considered the like safe vacation place to go at like as a graduation thing or whatever. But like as a crazy kooky spooky one, the light music club girls went to London instead, where it's not as many Asians.
Going to Hawaii in Japan,
it's like a 4-hour flight, by the way, from Japan to Hawaii. It's like right there. It's as close as California. Damn. So yeah, 4 or 5 hours, whatever.
As close to Japan as California.
Well, Hawaii's in between California and Japan, like right equidistant or so. Yeah.
Hawaii is got it.
It's an island, Ben. It's an island.
Okay.
It's an ocean.
It's an ocean, Ben. De wave, man, de wave. And I was gonna say that I desperately want to go get both curry and, oh, I already had ramen with a little Naruto in it. It was fucking sick, dude. Oh,
what does Naruto taste like?
They're a little, frankly, you always get them in ramen,
it's
so they
the,
taste
the,
like ramen broth.
Little cake thing with the spiral
it's
on
fish.
It, yeah?
That's right. Okay. But they absorb the flavor, so it is made of fish, but it just tastes like, you know, the miso soup or whatever you got in there. But I cannot, I'm going to go get curry, and it's going to be great, and I can't wait.
If I can divert for a second, I forgot to mention when we were talking about Hippo, when you thought of when you brought up that you were watching BreadTube, I wanted to say that I was like I was sick and tired and I wasn't gonna take it anymore.
Mm.
So I've decided to start subtly radicalizing the killers. I went to Cop Kill Town and I created a separate a channel in Cop Kill Town that anyone there can see. It's called the Radicalization Station. And all it is, it's just every video that Thought Slime makes. Because I thought that was pretty on brand. So
yeah,
the Radicalization Station is just where you go to watch Thought Slime and discover that all cops are bad and that we should dissolve the state. And that's it.
Man, I can't tell you about a time where things didn't improve when my video games went political. I can't think of any examples.
Yes,
it's straight up, man.
Unfortunately, mm-hmm. It's true. Endless War has gone political, and it's not fun anymore.
All right. I learned one other fun fact that people may be amused by, which is, you know those famous Hawaiian shirts, Ben, that you and I wore from Billabong with the flames and all those?
I had so many in so many colors.
They were wonderful. Well, so like traditional Hawaiian shirts out here, they're like officials will wear them. They're like actual like uniforms for things, or they're like considered dressing up or whatever.
Are they the same pattern? Or?
It's hot.
No, all different patterns. So it's very colorful and all different stuff. But like I learned the origin of them at some, I don't know, we were somewhere or something, and there was a sign or whatever that just said like, did you know? I think we're at a museum or like Pearl Harbor or something. That originally the famous Hawaiian shirts. The Japanese, like immigrants or whatever, came from Japan to Hawaii to look for work. They'd work in the fields and stuff. And their kimonos, which were all different patterns and colors, they would cut and taper down and pin in place so that they could work on the plantations. And it's those, like, morphed Japanese kimonos, like, in this Hawaiian style, that became the Hawaiian shirts we know today. So it's actually a Japanese thing originally.
Fucking
that was just adapted.
Isn't
I know, you can't escape them. Every culture is
a whole
sick.
Island of weeaboos. Just despicable.
Culture is their number one export. All right, let's do next one, The Truth. You ready for The Truth, boys?
Oh, no,
boys?
Probably not.
I'm ready.
Honestly.
All right, here we go. Okay. 1, 2, 3, go.
I've done it. I figured out the big secret of the whole world.
Hmm.
Everything is going to come apart after this.
Okay.
Holy shit.
Sex isn't real. Hmm. I've made 25 laps around the sun.
Yeah.
I have seen no physical evidence of sex at all. Babies, the stork is the actual way babies come from.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Is they're pulling the wool over your eyes when they say it wasn't. Sex isn't real. Porn is a whole psyop by the government.
Mm. Yeah.
There's no other way to explain it. How could I, after 25 years, not have had sex? If it was
the
real.
Only way.
It's gotta be fake. I figured it out, guys. Holy shit.
I mean, good logic.
I mean, even if sex was real, I don't know why we have to bring babies in, because I've seen correlation between like people having sex and babies, but like I haven't seen causal link.
It's not there.
Proven.
It's not there. Yeah. Yeah.
It's you know, you sleep in the same bed with a woman, and then an angel comes, and you know, they talk to the woman about something, and something happens.
But tell you what,
and there's a baby. Super
the truth. Gross. Why don't you bring me your girlfriend or your mother, and we will try to figure out this causal link. Just the two of us. We'll see what happens. Won't that be?
Wait, you cut out. Did you say your girlfriend or mother?
I did. These are the two options on the table.
That's how you do it.
No age is too aged.
All right. Next, we got 4 Nick 8. Okay, all right, here we go. 1, 2, 3, go.
Hey, PCP.
Hey.
So the dating sim is being released this week.
Oh my god, that's right.
I'm an undecided dater from Nevada. I still don't know if I should date Tom or Digi or Brad, or maybe I'm just better off being a MGTOW. Why should I date you specifically? What's your position on gay marriage? Personally, I don't want to date a candidate that supports it. It goes against my founding principles,
like right.
liberty, having small government, and sucking a dick. Win me over, PCP.
Pete 2020.
Make my heart flutter, make my mind explode, and make my soul yours.
Right. Now, this guy's got a winning attitude. I'm happy to his vote.
Yeah, like, Valentine's Day is the 14th?
The 14th, 5 days away from when we're recording.
So that'll be out. No, that is coming out the day.
The day. When you hear this, it will be out. Holy Christ.
It will have, unless something fucks, unless they fuck it up, unless Shadow Incorporated, causes, deliberate app failure.
I'm part of Valentine's Day, and Valentine's Day gets canceled for everyone.
Valentine's
Day will get replaced with Valentine's Gay, and it's going to be a nightmare for this guy, if no one else.
So, yeah, it should be out right now as you hear my voice.
Yeah, how exciting.
You should
Link in the doobly doo.
You should not go for me.
No.
I don't want anyone to
reverse
fuck
psychology,
me.
Right?
I don't want anyone to fuck me. Please
I don't know this for sure.
I don't consent. Hey, viewers, I'm saying right now that I do not consent.
Oh Lord. Hey, do you guys know
what he means by that?
Dating sims come in all stripes and all sizes and shapes. Is there sex in this? Like, are there sex scenes? Because that's a pretty clean divide between dating sims.
I have not heard of any actual, like, even implied sex scenes. But
there could be. But I have no actual evidence.
I don't know who would have drawn them.
I'm very curious.
Of evidence of sex is not evidence of the absence of sex.
Is evidence of abstinence.
Maybe there is sex, but it's behind. You have to like hack into the mainframe and remove some code or something.
Yeah, AKA maybe. Open the folder of all the images and look.
Yes.
Or maybe
correct.
You have to, pledge to the silver or gold tiers on their PCP dating sim Patreon in order to get the exclusive. I've seen some shit like that. Oh, it makes me mad. Oh, I don't like it. I'm filled with fury. But hopefully not this
time. Maybe they did like DLC? Funny sensor bars that don't. There's nothing under the sensor.
I mean, there's plenty of room.
I don't know.
There's plenty of room for comedic sex scenes that aren't like actually poor. I don't care either way. I will experience whatever.
They
happens.
Make you laugh, but they're still fucking hot though.
Hell yeah, that's the idea.
It'll be all in text, and then the sex happens.
Unga bunga. my catchphrase.
The version of the avatar with the glasses slightly tilted and the hair ruffled.
That sounds great. I hope that happens. I guess we'll see. All right, anyway, go check it out. It's at PCP Dating, I think is the at. I think it's at PCP Day. We'll put a link below.
Let me make absolutely sure.
Okay. Okay. Yes. Please. Let's take a pause.
Yeah, because there was another one. The
joke one. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is. Yeah, PCP Dating.
At PCP Dating on Twitter, you can definitely get it there on the day. So be prepared. We will.
Do they have any updates?
I haven't checked. What, do you see anything there? I assume you're looking.
A week ago, they tweeted, "Hold on to your butts." PCP dating sim script. Okay. There's a picture of the script.
Oh, the giant text dump. Like that's gotta be 200 pages, 100, 200 something. Yeah, that's a lot of text. Why did you print that out?
They've been a little quiet. Their last tweet was on January 30th.
Well,
maybe it was already nearly done. They got nothing to say.
Maybe.
Maybe they're just cranking.
I mean, it's gonna be too late to hear this. But certainly on the day you hear this, everybody, I'm sure they'll listen to this episode. At least I hope so. One of them, likely to. Let us know at TP Krasners at least once. We'll make sure we get the word out if we forget, because it's on Friday. So, it might be. It's going to be Aloha Friday. So that's going to be a day to take it sleazy like the Democratic Party. All right, next one. Let's listen to Brad is a God.
Don't fucking say that name.
All right, here we go. Brad is God. 1, 2, 3, go.
I quickly want to thank Brad Garlinghouse, my Lord and Savior, Brad, for allowing me and my poor, poor fellows to listen to the BGE Montelcast.
Oh, God,
really nice of him. He's really turning the channel around. It's giving it a new life. And thank you, Brad, and fuck you, Nate.
This guy sounds like Brad
Gunninghouse is for the people. He is the one of the good billionaires. He is redistributing the wealth. He has taken. Did you know that 1% of the Best Guy Ever listeners have access to the 99% of the Patreon exclusive? Not anymore, baby.
No.
Power to the people. Brad is a fucking hardcore right wing populist. Everyone will listen to these podcasts, and then we will get the Jews somewhere. Yeah, not saying where. Happen. Don't worry about it.
What was I going to say? Remember that website we discovered? Maybe I shouldn't talk about, but who gives a fuck? There was a website that, like, their purpose in being was to, like, make all, like, paywall-blocked content, like, non-paywall-blocked, and they had uploaded, like, every PCP bonus episode and stuff.
Yes. I don't remember what it was called, but I know that there are things like that.
Yeah, me neither. And that, look, that's fine. I mean, whatever. Hope people support if they like the show and all that. But I wonder if that's been done. We all have, like, basically all of us have, like, our patron only podcast that we're doing now.
Actually, it's funny because, like, I'm not gonna say anything, but, like, the Slime and Punishment finale images that I've been uploading.
Yeah,
I think Christine would have an opinion about them. And part of me wonders if some troll, if some, like, Kiwi Farms troll or other isn't gonna, like, pledge $10, get them, and then, like, post them early and be like, Christine, look at this. Honestly, I don't know if... I mean, it would be
I sure
be
hope you don't pledge the money.
I sure hope somebody doesn't give me $10 to get access to this exclusive juicy content that would surely cause an incredible stir.
And give and endear you lifelong to Christine Weston Chandler, no doubt. Making her subject to any and all trolls that may be concocted.
I sure hope there's no one around looking to stir the pot a little bit who might not have some extra change lying around.
God, that sounds fantastic. All right, moving on. Let's go to Red Oranges, Bic Boy, a.k.a. Long JJ, or Jelly Bean.
That's good.
Those are all his names, I guess. All right, let's hear it. One, two, three, go.
Nate, I've heard that you like grapefruits.
Yeah, true.
Me too.
There's this new thing called red oranges.
Yeah.
They're oranges and grapefruits combined.
Okay.
They're so fucking good.
Hmm.
Don't show this on the podcast. I just wanted you to know.
Too late. Fuck you, dude. I'm playing on the podcast.
Okay. Yeah. This guy's a fucking moron, okay? Let me tell you all. Fuck this guy.
Yeah.
Fuck you and your grapefruits. You. Okay, first of all, red oranges. No, they're called blood oranges. And they are not even. They're not a cross between.
This is a different thing? Maybe this is a new thing. I don't know.
I just Googled it. There's no such thing as a.
A red orange?
Wait. Okay, a blood orange, it's a natural
mutation.
A natural mutation of an orange, which is itself a hybrid, probably between the pomelo and the tangerine. Okay.
Okay,
so,
right.
Yeah, blood orange is not half grapefruit. You fucking idiot.
He didn't say blood oranges were. He's talking about red.
He said red, but there's no such thing. There's no such thing as a red orange.
Okay, fair enough. He seemed to be implying that they're new. So maybe they're local or some, I don't know. Maybe it was at his local farmer's market and some guy there.
If he's talking about blood oranges, we've known about them for years. Well, Dexter ate one every fucking episode.
Is that true?
Yeah. Apparently, the opening sequence to Dexter, he ate a blood orange.
I was thinking of Dexter's laboratory.
It was supposed to be evocative, you understand, because he's a blood.
Well, see, I was thinking Dexter's laboratory, so that was the...
Oh, no. And that's wrong.
He ate those because of his ginger hair.
Makes him really smart, yeah. Makes sense.
There apparently is a cross between a grapefruit and an orange. It's called an orangello.
Okay, I think I've heard of that. I've heard of that. This guy had an alternate name that was Jelly Bean, Jelly Bean?
Orangello
was
hybrid citrus fruit believed to have originated in Puerto Rico. A cross between a grapefruit and an orange.
Okay.
That's funny because an orange is a cross between a pomelo and a tangerine.
Well, all right, look, all
so
this
then
is
you
great
take a
and all,
pomelo and a tangerine and cross up. That with a grapefruit, and then you get an orangello. Well, actually, no, I think a grapefruit is also a pomelo hybrid.
Blood
so I guess, yeah, you are doubling up on the pomelo.
Okay. Listen, none of this matters because his main point
You get a strawberry and a carrot, and you get you get something that you don't want. You get rhubarb.
Yeah, you probably do. Listen, this guy's like, oh, I've got, okay. I've solved it. I combine the orange with the grapefruit. What?
No,
what, Ben?
God, I love this shit. Yeah, a grapefruit is a cross. An accidental cross between a sweet orange and a pomelo. So an orange is a tangerine pomelo. A grapefruit is an orange pomelo. So it's a tangerine pomelo.
Wait.
So it's just
two parts pomelo,
one part tangerine, and that's a grapefruit. And then so you cross them
with an orange.
Five-sixth pomelo, one part tangerine, and you call that an orangello.
Wow. I guess it makes sense, kind of. Okay, I had never heard of a pomelo until right now.
I have had a pomelo. Are not good. No.
Okay, no, but...
That's why oranges win.
Imagine a grapefruit,
yeah.
But like it's like huge. It's like massive, like football size.
Okay.
But you open it up, and like... most of it is just rind. Like, most of it is just, like, white, fluffy rind that you throw away.
Yeah,
and then about a regular amount of grapefruit, of grapefruit-ish flesh in the middle, mm-hmm. and you eat it, and it just doesn't taste like anything. It's like grapefruit, but, like, bigger, with less edible part, and it tastes worse.
Here's a cross-section. Yeah, look at all that. That's a waste. That's too much fluff. I mean, I kind of love it aesthetically, but
I have heard that, like, I don't know. There's, I guess, people use it in like vodka or something. Like okay. It has its uses, but like, I don't think many people eat it because like it doesn't taste that great to just eat.
Okay, but so it was a tangerine crossed with a pomelo that made oranges.
Apparently, an orange is a tan. No, the orange. This one says the orange is a hybrid between a pomelo and mandarin.
Okay,
I'm getting conflicted reports here.
Okay, you
what
know
what? With all these fucking fruits?
I am way into all orange. This. This is fascinating. But the point I was going to make.
I love this shit.
Listen, his original point was like, Nate, I do love grapefruits. It's true. I'm a huge fan of grapefruit. It's better than oranges. Fuck oranges.
Me too. I was the original. I liked it first.
I mean, I'm sure that's true.
I'm out here.
Ben likes it first because he's oldest.
I'm out here standing for my man, the grapefruit. Shout outs to grapefruit, dude. Every fucking
Why
time.
Why is it called grapefruit? It's such
I
so
don't
big
know why.
Compared
every fucking
to a grape.
Time I'm speed running bikini bottom.
I'm fucking no
whatever.
Clipping through the floor
battle, SpongeBob
to get to
battle
a
for bikini bottom. I say shout outs to grapefruit for powering this
Bro,
run.
You know, do anyone remember that kid who no clipped through the floor to get to the snack drawer faster to get his precious grapefruits and like coming home from elementary school every day? That was me. I admit it. It was me. I was speed running in a big way. Look.
God, I remember no clipping at school.
No clipping
memories.
Through the bathroom stall when someone else is inside.
And rolling out of class.
The blood orange page says that the orange is a hybrid between pomelo and tangerine.
Okay.
But the orange page says that the orange is a cross between pomelo and mandarin.
Which is called mandarin orange,
but it is not the same as a sweet orange, which is what we call an orange.
It's all
here
fucked up. I guess their factions are at war about the true history. I don't know.
My friend, my roommate has a tree. Oh, the sad story of the Calamundin tree, which he called a scarlet lime, but he called it scarlet limes, but I think it's actually more commonly called the Philippine lime. I think a scarlet lime is actually something different, but it is they're like limes, but I guess they turn orange, but they're still very tart but he's got this potted tree, and it last year in like the spring it flowered and it smelled so good. It was like such a sweet smelling, like nice smelling flowering tree. It was like really great.
Mm-hmm.
But then I guess it got like put in the wrong place, like the weather turned bad at the wrong time or something, and it lost like all of its, it like died.
Damn.
But not entirely though. So he had to like cut like basically the entire tree down, and it just sprouted like one little leaf from like the side of like the little like stick, the little like foot long stick sticking out of the dirt pot. But now it has kind of grown like a little bit more. it's not quite a bush, but it's sort of like a little bunch of leaves just kind of coming out the bottom of this one like stick. Mm-hmm. And like, boy, I'm rooting for it. I really hope it flowers again.
Were they green or were they orange?
Because it was not, yeah. Well, if it's like fully mature, they look like that. It only sprouted like one lime and it did not fully mature. So it never turned orange. It had like one actual like fruit on it and it did not, it was green because it did not like fully mature.
Sure. Well, listen, this guy's point was that I got a genius idea.
You gotta smell them. At some point in your life, smell the flowers of a Calamondin.
To respond...
Or a Calamansi, I guess it's also called.
Who the fuck was it? Red Oranges, who didn't want me to play this voicemail, but I did it anyway. He's like, I'll infuse a grapefruit in an orange. It'll be like a grapefruit, but the size of an orange. Why the fuck would I want a grapefruit the size of an orange when I could just take a normal big grapefruit, which is just more fruit? Why would anyone want that?
Is bigger.
Retarded. I like that they're bigger. It's so much better that they're bigger. I hate how small oranges are. That the main reason I don't eat oranges is because it's so much work for less fruit than a grapefruit. It makes me mad.
I wonder if an orangello is good.
I'm sure it's acceptable. I don't know. Maybe not.
I'll give it a shot.
Okay, give it a shot.
What about a lemon?
Get the fuck out of here with that. All right, let's go to our next one. All right, these are peas in a pod.
I mean, apparently an orangello is just like sweeter than a grapefruit, so I guess it's just like right in between. I prefer grapefruit to orange, so I would probably just rather go for a fucking grapefruit. So
yeah, obviously we're not these cowards we're talking about before who put sugar on the grapefruit. Like idiots, it doesn't need it.
Oh my god.
They should kill themselves.
What a disaster.
It's retarded. They're so good.
What is wrong with these people?
Why would you fuck with a delicious grapefruit like that? All right.
It's like turning it into
a fucking pie. Like, okay, I guess that's fine, but whatever. All right. Next,
waste of a good fruit, I tell you what. I got the local farmer's market. Mm-hmm. I got some, one of my friends got some grapefruit marmalade.
Okay,
it was really good.
Ooh.
It was really good.
Damn,
I gotta tell you.
I'm glad to hear it. All right, let's go to the next.
That's all I had to say about that.
Next voicemail. All right, here we go. This is the Lost Tapes Archive interlude. This was sent special. This is one of these long-ass messages that was sent with a link. So let's, this one isn't long, but all right, let's play it. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, go.
Previously on Lost Tapes Archives.
There it is.
Lost Tape Archive, Davu? Question mark?
Oh, God.
Jesus.
Horrific.
I think that was a war crime.
For this crime, he's putting straight into voice jail.
Can he exist in a superposition of jail and...
Voice Azkaban. Voice Limbo.
Yeah, I think he exists in both simultaneously.
Torn between two worlds.
Continue in part 2.
Wow. What did he even... I do not remember what he did to get
that was into... just That was just a recap.
That's right.
No, what he did was he did the lost tapes, and it was all about Davu's fetishes.
Oh, was it?
Extreme, and it was like, ooh.
Okay, thank God.
I had also forgotten, so I'm glad he reminded me.
Me too. One of these rare reviews I'm happy to see.
I needed to be caught up on the lore,
All right, well, let's jump into it. Them's Tapes number 2. Let's do it. 1, 2, 3, go.
I am trapped in a void. There is no life, no food, and no tapes. That's no good. If I could make the PCP laugh, they might set me free. But without any tapes, how can be?
Can I be in this voicemail?
Yeah!
Them snakes! What?
I was once a snake dealer, but I can be your tape dealer, too.
How are you here? There's no ground to slither on.
The method is irrelevant. I have a tape, and I am here. If only we had a cassette player to play it with.
Do not worry, my
know.
Slippery snaky fuck. I have a cassette player built into my fucking face.
Put it in, big boy.
Greetings. My name is Ben's Taint. I am a big smelly taint in the shape of a human.
Shut up.
A true walking keto crutch. I draw pictures.
Fuck
I
you.
Spew poo. BRB, I use blue.
No, turn it off.
Thank you. Buddy, I don't think this is going to cut it. We already did Ben Saint. Besides, I can tell it's you.
It's not my fault that all them snakes impersonators sound the same.
You'll need to awaken your Kundalini if you wish to find the funny fucking tapes.
I can provide them if I can find them.
To please the PCP, to be set free, the only payment is entertainment.
Ooh, it's true.
PCP, do you agree?
I agree. The only payment is entertainment. Yes.
I mean, it's yes, true.
That's good.
That's good stuff. That's good stuff in there.
I hope you don't expect to be let out of superposition voice jail.
I mean, he himself acknowledged that tape was some bullshit. We need, we gotta step it up.
I can't remember the tape. I don't think he's done me yet.
I don't think so.
And now he's done Ben twice.
He did you. He did everybody, didn't he?
I don't think he did everybody.
Shit,
in the process of doing everybody.
Someone let
us
know.
I know he did Digi and Jesse and you and Ben.
Yeah, right.
I don't know if he did Munchie
or
not.
Did you do Tom? I don't think he did Munchie. Okay, well, we shall see.
I do not remember. But I know one thing.
Please, in the comments, point to the time codes of the episodes of and we'll have a look.
Make a YouTube collaboration?
A highlight video. Reel.
Yeah, of all the them's tapes. Just do that for me, please. That would be great. Or at least tell us who. Put it in the comments. Say who's been done. I would love to be reminded. I am excited for more them's tapes to come. Please, God, bring them to me. Deliver them. And save this voicemail from Brad Garlinghouse's devious attempts to ruin all voicemails by sending in pure shit voicemails, as I'm sure he's responsible for all the bad
ones. If we just taint the PCP brand enough, he'll have to relinquish the channel.
It will become
a liability.
It'll be such a liability, yeah. Now that's a plan that can't fail. I guess that's it. Hey, you want to leave voicemails?
That's fucking
That was epic. That was great. Them snakes, guest star, them's tapes, good job. Hey, leave your epic voicemail at the SpeakPipe link down in the description. Do it up. We're waiting for them. What else is going on? We got Patreon people, patreon.com/theprocrastinators. Support this show for a couple of dollar dues on there per episode. $5, and you get the bonus episodes. The new one is already out, talking about comics and whatnot. Good time. And there's like 34, 35, something like that. What a deal. Incredible. You're welcome. Updates for all things that are happening on Twitter, at TPCrastinators on Twitter. I would, again, highly recommend you follow that, because when we make a new channel or get our channel back, that's going to be the place to
keep
our
eyes peeled. That's where we'll announce whatever it is.
That's it. I mean, you can follow me at Bestest Guy Ever. I'm also discussing these things. Ben at Ben Saint, or he's at Also Ugly.
Follow me on Twitter at patreon.com/BenSaint.
Any of us, we're letting people know as fast as we can. And of course, the RadCon Kickstarter is going on right now. And when you hear this,
it's almost over.
You'll have just a couple more days.
It's like, five days from now. The day that it ends will be like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
The 16th,
it'll be the Tuesday or the it'll like the Monday or like
18th,
Monday or Tuesday.
Yeah.
After so like this weekend is it?
That's right. This weekend.
That's it.
The 18th. I believe like the 17th, 18th. I think it's gonna end like the morning of the 18th because it like went live on like the morning of the 18th, like 31
yeah,
days before
okay.
or whatever. So
well.
So really, the 17th
so like
is
Monday,
last full
I think
day.
Monday night.
Yeah, pretty
Whatever.
Much.
Whatever. The point, this weekend is it. That's your last fucking chance.
Yep. So, hey, we got tons of good stuff on there. And now that, like, all our fucking tiers have been have been fulfilled, except for, you know, Digi's, light novels,
well,
still going for those.
We are close to the Brad lecture.
Yep.
And then after that, we've got the Digi's,
The fucking, higher chapters
the light,
are still waiting, yeah, of Road
novel,
to RadCon 4.
Should we...
The one.
Should we make a new one, like an intermediary, like for like 75k?
I see no 17? Reason why not. Fuck it. Let's
maybe
do it.
Maybe we should think about that.
Yeah, let's think about it.
But okay. Well,
let's
think about it. So we might even add more stretch goals. Dunno.
Mm-hmm.
Check it out.
But right now, we've got 224 backers, 8 days to go, 176% funded, 14,659. That's like, I think that's like $100 from when we started. So we're just like 300 and change away from the Brad Garlinghouse lecture. But there's more stuff beyond it. So check back when you see this. There may be updates added to it. So, how exciting for all of us. RadCon's coming up. No matter what, nothing's going to stop RadCon, baby. Hey, if you want to donate, you got, let's see, t-shirts, pins. You got the calendar. If you pledge $100, you'll be in the fucking PTA, making decisions, participate in live streams, part of the Discord, etc. If you go to that $200 tier, oh my god, you get the fucking, to be part of the art, part of the cast members of the RadCon art on the posters that will be sent out to everybody. You'll be immortalized for all time. If you want to be a mad lad, you can be in the Royal Rumble, like two people already have been. So hey, consider it.
I should say there's the dark. Have we talked about the dark champion? How like the
not much.
The $200 patrons, they will collectively build a Royal Rumble.
That's right.
Attendee. I don't know. There's like a whole bunch of like weird shit in the reward.
Yeah, read through. Yeah. It's good stuff. That's a good one. Yeah, we haven't talked about that. But like the $1,000 guys, they get their own individual champion. But at the
that represents them all collectively. Their attempt to subvert the caucus with Shadow Inc.
Shadow basically. The Hedgehog Inc. My favorite guy. All right, well, that's it for the episode, everybody. We'll be back again next week. I will be back from vacation, and we'll do this whole nightmare all over again. See you there, everybody. Bye.
Later. Save the PCP. Hashtag.
Save the PCP.
Tweet them up. Hashtag it.